What we saying?
Well, go on.
Yo,
another week, another podcast.
For real though.
And it's cold, man.
She's getting her hair now.
Is what?
She's getting her hair now.
Oh, listen, I'm freezing my tits off, love.
It's ridiculous.
You got tits?
I got titties. And ass.
What's that?
Raw, what's this, Crystal? Touching me. Get your hands off me.
It's a little double A cups.
The double A.
Mm. Better for us.
Better for us than double D's. All right, Gina, give us the special.
Hi, guys. It's just Gina here with Big Man News, Crystal and Dami. And this is Meet Us After 7.
Masterclass, eh? You know, do I do that on the buttons?
You bare gas.
Oh, shit. What are we saying, though? We're at the pod today?
Who's ready to pod?
Read the pod.
Who's ready to pod?
Dickheads.
Who's ready to pod today?
Yeah.
We podding.
I'm ready.
Give
to
me
pod.
Some energy. Give me some energy. New brand got energy.
Give me some energy.
Give me some energy.
No, wait, Gina, your one is so lax. You're like, give me some energy.
Give me some energy. Sick, last week it was Gladys. This week you're sick.
Yeah, and I've effed up my back, so I'm not really.
Don't transfer your negativity to me, please.
Negativity, please.
Crystal's back. If you're watching on YouTube, Crystal and Dami are both not on camera.
Because they think they're too nice.
No.
Dami ain't got a trim and Crystal's wearing a headscarf.
I don't have a trim either. That's why I've got my hair on.
In my looks, unfortunately.
Yeah.
No, but the thing is, before, like, I invited him on Apple Cuts before and he said, oh, he doesn't want to be on camera. Mm. Then he came on camera, but then had his hood up. But I thought you were over the camera shyness. So what's reverted you back to it?
I don't know. It's one of those days, man. Just don't want to be on camera.
Them ones, he ain't got 3 minutes. I hear that still.
No, he's on the camera. No, he's wearing a hat and he's got a
yeah, beard, you have a hat.
His beard's fine, so I don't know.
I got my head wrapped and I can't be on TV.
Just don't want to be on camera, man.
No, it's fine, but I'm trying to find out the reason.
It's not fine. I'm joking.
Look at the eyes, though. It's not fine.
No, it is. I'm joking. I'm not trying to reduce anyone's experience here, please.
Can we move the coat, though? The coat's not great for, like, the aesthetics.
Okay, fair enough.
Whose coat is that?
Mine, but I'm not moving it, though.
Why?
Because you want to move it.
You're immature. Canada Goose.
Wait, how can you call me immature?
Fine, but I said I'm not going to move it because
you want me to
move it.
Oh yeah, I'm childish, isn't it?
You think?
Feck.
Childish.
I said, look at her, she's just really
chat. She's so fleeting herself.
I am though. I'm not going to lie, I'm chuffed.
Why?
I don't know, it's funny.
That's something to be chuffed about.
No, I'm just funny, isn't it?
Yeah. Are you?
Yeah, for me.
Canada Goose. Mm. Canada Goose. Mm. Hustleism. Mm.
SN1.
Where's that hustleism? Bubble jacket for the winter.
Come and see.
Where's my freebies? That's what I'm about to get a couple of jackets.
Have you been to the shop?
You know what? I went down Peckham High Street the other day on the way to my dentist, thinking in my head for some reason.
Your dentist is in Peckham.
Big man, relax.
I thought
it's right there. It's after the NatWest.
No, I thought I knew where it was. So I'm like, yeah. When I walk down there, I'm gonna see hustle.
Mine as well.
I was like, right, where is it?
Yeah, but it's actually after NatWest though.
Where though?
On the same road. It's on the same side as NatWest.
Oh, so it's not on Peckham High Street?
No, it is.
No, but why is your dentist in Peckham?
What's wrong with Peckham?
No, yeah, but you what's don't wrong with Peckham? Live in Peckham.
No, so you're I'm from South way, originally.
But then you want to change your dentist?
I haven't changed yet.
And wow. You shouldn't.
What, just go all the way to Peckham?
So what's wrong with Peckham?
Peckham's not that far, to be honest.
From Canary Wharf?
Nah, it's not that far.
Oof.
Not that far.
If he walks right, it's literally
walk
one
from
train.
His house. Man.
No, hold on, quickly.
Walks from his house.
Sorry.
Actually, no. If he walks,
you didn't press record here, so I pressed it myself. Ah, cool. I clapped a few times, so keep track.
So keep track. So Brent, is that a no then?
No.
Okay, fix.
Hold on. Brent, is everything fine?
Did I leave my water in the car? What?
Is everything fine?
The whole set of cascading things because of the toilet. Usage.
Yeah.
Just myself and my
Okay. Yeah. Oh.
I'm bare confused.
No, because this brother used his toilet and now it's the issue.
Don't mind anything. It's just.
Okay, cool.
I can hear that, innit? Yeah.
All right. The moral of the story is use toilets in your damn house. Your own house, motherfucker. All right, let's get back to this podcast, shall we? Ready for the mature counting?
No, we're not.
I'm playing.
What's in your docket though? Because today.
Don't worry. Man's got the docket for us.
Oh, I hear
still.
That. Good.
You know what I mean? And obviously, Crystal's here for the blackness.
Race report.
Oh, for the Crystal, race relations expert. What's new on the streets, Chris? Anything developing?
Well, Yusuf, I'm dead. There are a few ladies.
I'm not.
A few ladies.
I'm not involved, bruv.
A few ladies. No, I'm joking.
All right, so today.
Has there been anything racy this week, though? I don't think so.
No, but if there is, we'll get to it later.
Cool.
So, you know. In our group chat.
Is this the Ghana Must Stay group chat?
Yes.
I've asked many times.
No, I know.
I'm going to start getting pissed off now.
Do you know what? The last time I was here, I remember you asking as well.
Thank you.
So basically, yeah.
Thank you.
There's a rule in the chat, I think. I think you have to be either from Ghana or Nigeria.
Yo. What? What kind of stupid
rule? That was Sid's rule. That was Sid's rule.
I'm messaging him, bro. What the fuck is this?
That was Sid's rule. He said, you're neither Guinean.
Wait, Guinean?
Ghanaian or Nigerian.
I'm messaging them now.
What did Nigerian. Cardi B call Ghanaians again? Ghanatidians.
Ghanatidians,
yeah.
Nah, I'm messaging Jesse, bruv.
So, come. I mean, so shout out to Temi, who got married.
Oh, you don't have this debate.
No, but he put it on his podcast. So,
no, we can, yeah. For real.
So shout out to Temi from...
Because this morning it was...
90s Babies show. He got married last week. Congratulations.
Oh, the trad.
Thank you, Crystal. Okay, there you go. Crystal.
What's the trap?
Crystal, God will bless you. God will honor you. Your household will never lack.
Gee, remember, this is a Gloria versus Sid debate.
No.
Not a Yusuf versus Gloria debate.
No, I know.
Cool.
Fair enough. Okay, all right, today I'm going to be Gloria and you're going to be Sid.
Cool. So Temi put on his latest episode, he was saying how he saved a lot of money. And I'm going to...
Quote unquote, please.
No, let me play his clip.
Yeah.
So then we have full context and there's no like he say, okay. She say, whatever. But please take his words for what they are.
Mm-hmm.
And don't put your own words in his mouth,
yeah.
Based on your set of beliefs, mm-hmm. on what you think of.
All right, sorry.
I'm just saying, because you already started with the trad stuff. Remind me of
Gloria. I just asked a question.
No, Crystal, when you get context, you'll get why.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Hold on. Let me find a clip. Is this it? No, that's not it. All right, here we go.
Oh, it stopped. The sound.
But the morning invites went to like my mum and dad's friends and their dad's friends and all the
people. No, but read the caption so first before you...
Marky was about 1-5.
Pause, sorry.
All right, so the caption is... It's not hard to save on your wedding if you bring it back to basics. Here's the cost of mine. I repeat, it's not hard to save on your wedding.
Mm-hmm.
Wedding.
Mm.
All right, cool.
They probably would have came.
I'll start again.
But the morning invites went to like my mum and dad's friends and their mum and dad's friends and all the people that need to be there. So Marky was about 1-5. Let's say we did probably over $1,000 on drinks. Obviously, other people would have brought drinks as well. But in terms of what we actually spent, my brother and sister contributed to that. Photography, videography, and DJ probably would have came up to maybe like between 1-2 to maybe 1-7. So, and then obviously food. I don't know how much they spent on food because her mum just said she's going to cover that. So I think... Let's say food might have been like 1-1.5, and they cooked it themselves as well. So they shout out to auntie, mum, everybody. They were still cooking that day. So that saved mad money. I think overall, it wouldn't have costed, it would have been like between 6-5 to 7, bruv.
Wow, that's very good.
And man had everyone there that man needed there. Like, obviously, aunties and that cleared out. So I was thinking, oh, shoot, I probably could have told more people to come. But it was what it needed to be, bruv.
Mm-hmm.
It was literally what it needed to be. And there's like a video of my brother, he videoed me and he said, what are you saying just before you go in? And I was like, bruv, save your coin on your wedding. Like, I'm doing it for everyone. I told the man them, because when I proposed, man them were like, oh, bruv, you're putting me under bear pressure. I said, don't worry. I'm going to bring it back for the man them. Everyone chill on their weddings, because I am proof. You can enjoy yourself. Have all the necessary people there. And do your wedding and be married, fam. It's about the union. Man, I'm worried about partying too much.
All right, so when Sid put that in the group, Gloria came with what exactly? What was her first?
So basically, her thing was, okay, it wasn't a wedding, it was a trad. So she was like, you haven't told me anything that I don't already know. It was like, obviously, as someone who's planning to get married sooner rather than later, you're interested in this thing. So if you're saying you've helped people save coins on their wedding, I've got my pen and paper ready to take notes. But you're not talking about your wedding, you're talking about your trad. Anyone can have a trad in their garden and save money. Like, nothing you said is gems. It's not common sense, but it's like, if, especially for Ghanaians, because we don't, I've said this before on the pod, how Ghanaian culture generally, we don't do big trads. It's usually done at home. Do you get what I mean? So based on what he had, that's what a standard trad is. So trads aren't expensive. So her thing was, you kind of sold a dream because it's not a wedding, it's a trad. So obviously, Sid, and like when he said that Temi's wedding, straight away you were like, he's trad. So you were differentiating the two. So obviously, Jesse was like, what's the difference? It's the same thing. And G was like, no, it's not. And he was like, rather, some people don't do white weddings. Some people generally just have a trad and that's their wedding. And she's like, yeah, cool, but that's not a wedding. Like, I know what you're saying, but you and I both know, if I sent you a wedding invitation saying you're accordingly invited to Gloria Adjiman's wedding, you're not going to expect to come to a marquee in my garden or have a traditional ceremony in the house. It's going to be, do you know what I mean? So if I was doing a trad, even if that was my only wedding and I sent you an invitation, it would say the traditional engagement, yes or no. So there's a difference between the two. So obviously they were just going back and forth and Sid was like, oh, there's no difference. You don't get, like, he didn't get it. I wasn't really engaging, but I was like, Sid, I get what Gloria is saying. Not taking away anything that he said, because like some people spend 20 grand plus on trads, which I think is mind blowing. So that in itself, like, and it looks lit. So I'm not mad at that. I think the debate literally was just was the whole thing of a trad versus a wedding.
And then what I was saying was, how do we know that to him, well, how do we know in the first place that they're having both a trad and a white wedding? This might just be it. Because the way he said it was pretty conclusive. Like, this is how much I saved on my wedding. He didn't say, this is how much I saved on my trad. He said my wedding. So when I was in the group, I was like, you know what? I get where both of you are coming from, but we don't know. This could be it. And if this is it, then he saved peas on his wedding because it only cost him 7 bags.
Fair, I get it. And Charlie, what's my own? Am I married?
That's what I said. I said
you were like, as long as man's happy.
I said, look,
man's married, it is what it is. Yeah.
Trad, white, trad, big man, it's not our business.
Yeah.
Like, if he's happy, he's happy. It doesn't matter whether or not that's his trad or that's his main wedding, but or he can do both.
I'm not gonna lie, it's the same thing I would do. Like, I wouldn't do a massive trad. It would be intimate in a house if I can, if not, it'd be in a hall, but still, it wouldn't be like a massive embankment hall. Do you know what I mean? It wouldn't be on those levels. Obviously, I'm even surprised because he's Nigerian, and from what I understand, Nigerians generally, but I guess it's because the bride's Ghanaian. So, and I know that with most things, you kind of take on the bride's culture when you're getting
married.
Was
it in her house or his house?
Because
technically, shouldn't it be in her house on the Ghanaian culture?
Yeah, so I'm assuming it was. I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know how these things work. But the thing is a trad and a white wedding a necessity? Do you have to have both? Can you just have one? Is it?
No, so
you
basically,
have to have a trad though.
You don't have to. It's more for your parents.
For your African parents to respect your union.
It has to be trad.
You have to have a trad.
I don't think so. I think it depends. No, because it depends on your parents. I know people that are African that haven't had trads, but they've got white weddings. So,
really?
Yeah.
They didn't have trads.
Alan didn't have a trad. You went to Jamaica even.
Oh, you mean our age. Okay.
Yeah. I'm saying like, it depends on, there's no rule of thumb. There's no like,
have they done some sort of ceremony? Because that's the same thing with my cousin. So my cousin got married to like an English man. And literally, debating as to whether she wanted the trad. And if she was like, the trad's not for me, it's for my auntie and my uncle. And it literally got to like the day before the wedding, when she was like, okay, my family was like, okay, there's still been no trad, nothing done. My uncles were screwing. They had to do the trad in the morning.
Yeah, but that's
in like a random room.
That's more for them though.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Yeah, for a lot of African people, like, you have to have some sort of, it doesn't have to be like a trad, but there has to be like that traditional ceremony.
You can still have a white wedding, right?
Yeah.
No, sorry, what I was going to say, you can still have a a trad and a white wedding combined, as in it's a white wedding, but you're just wearing trad and you're doing your vows and that?
No.
No?
You can't.
So a traditional is the ceremony. It's not just about what you wear.
It's the ceremony.
It's the actual ceremony.
No, no, that's what I mean. So the white...
Because you said you wear wedding, trad. So...
No, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying, can you have the white wedding ceremony,
yeah,
but you wear trad?
Yeah, but it's not.
Yeah, but it's not a
wedding.
Traditional
engagement. No, it's not a traditional
wedding.
Engagement. It's the traditional engagement ceremony.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, so that's
I'm
the giving of the dowry.
Best of both worlds.
Yeah, but you're not really.
No, unless you have the traditional engagement ceremony, yeah. It won't be classed as a trad and a wedding. You're just wearing native wear.
Yeah,
that's what so I mean.
No, yeah, but that's not.
All right, cool. So explain to me, the novice in the room right now, about the wedding.
So a traditional wedding.
What elements
a traditional
come together
wedding
to make a trad? A trad.
Yeah, I'll actually.
It depends on. It depends on. Because
remember, everyone's country is different, though. So
okay, I think Ghanaian is very close. Ghanaian is very close to Congolese, right? So it's like when you get engaged.
Yeah.
The man's family will write a letter and say we want to take so and so's hand in marriage.
I don't even think you.
I want to take Akua's hand in hand in marriage, and then that formally tells your the bride's family to prepare a list of all the things that they want in the dowry.
See, yeah.
I don't know. I'm the Congolese. And even my cousin who got married to Ghanaian guy, that's what they also followed as well.
I don't think we've... I've never heard anyone write a letter.
Really?
Trads, no. But yeah. I just know that you speak to the bride's family.
Yeah, so some people do formal...
It's called koko knocking. You go there before. That's what we call it. It's a knocking. And so it's like, I've seen a tree in your house. Like, they speak in proverbs. I'm not even joking. About I've seen like a tree or a branch or something in your household that I like, whatever. You write a list... As the bride's family, you write a long list of all, like, the dowry payment, basically, yeah. As to what you're going to accept in exchange for your daughter's hand in marriage. And then they literally come together. And then on the day of the ceremony, you come with all the gifts, everything on their list.
Yep.
You present it to the family. They can still turn around and tell you no, to be honest with you.
I've been to one like that.
They can literally tell you no.
I've literally been to one
and
like
take
that.
Take the gifts. Yes. And
wait, so they take the gifts?
Yeah, say no.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, fucking mind.
Yeah,
I've literally been to one where they're like, okay, so we all go home now, and everyone just got up and went.
But they took the gifts.
No, the groom's family took back their shit and went home.
Oh, I was gonna say
because it's for the bride's family to agree, like the dad. Yeah.
The thing is, it's not the dad,
it's the elder.
Yeah.
If
the eldest
Noah,
man,
we gotta stop this.
The eldest man in the village or the eldest man in the family.
Not me. No. Speak correctly.
Just let the Iv live.
No, I'm not gonna
let the Iv live.
Sorry.
It's not every day.
It's also because I think you have a slight lisp.
I do.
Yeah, so it's
the dentist confirmed it still.
No, it's fine.
Dentist listen. In Peckham.
In Peckham.
Peckham.
He told me that my tongue is large and it pushes.
Oh, I don't want to hear this. Pause.
Pause. He says that my tongue pushes against my teeth and it's proper, like it's protruding. I said, you know what? That makes sense because I got a little bit of a lisp still.
Lisp. I hear that. Anyway, yeah. Go on.
What I'm saying is, if you're...
Sorry, go and proceed.
What's that that Christian thing that you always shout out?
Jesus Christ.
No, that's not it. The armor thing.
Oh, armor of God.
Armor of God. Armor of God.
You're an idiot, man.
If your fiance, mm-hmm. you and your fiance, you wanted to get
my
married,
fiance.
But you knew that your fiance, mm-hmm. you knew that he had to go and speak to that way, whatever.
Yeah.
He came to your house with all the gifts and that, and your dad said no. Mm-hmm. Are you still getting married to him?
Man, I'm joking. I'm like, father, what do you mean? I'm joking. I don't know if you can. Yeah. I mean, me being
Whoa.
Me, no.
It's final.
No. You
think it's gonna be
reduce it.
No, but I was gonna say me being me.
Yeah.
Like me being me.
Yeah.
Redeals it. Like, okay, just don't come. It's all right.
But I think it'll be seen as great disrespect in your
family. Honor and whatnot. Okay, I don't know. Okay. But anyway, you're on the day. Both families come together. You both have a representation. So you have someone that represents the bride's family, someone that represents the grooms, and they're both like elders.
It's called
and
a representative.
What was I saying?
Or what you Nigerians call an alaga.
You said a representation. You said you both have a representation.
Potato, potato.
Representative.
Anyway.
Reduce.
So they communicate with each other on your behalf.
Yeah.
And then they speak to the father of the bride, and the father of the bride basically says whether he allows... the guy to take his daughter's hand in marriage. Then he asks the daughter, like, is this the person you want to marry? Yeah. Is this what you want?
She was like, yes, Papa.
So a tribe is more than just wearing native, eh?
Yeah, yeah. So there's a proper whole ceremony.
But has
everybody else in Africa.
Has anyone been like...
Well, I've never been married before, have I?
I think there's even... There might be a... Well, there is actually. There's stage before... The trad normally as well.
Yeah, for Ghanaians.
Introduction.
Introduction.
Yeah.
So that's the thing. Maybe that's because maybe that's why you haven't seen a letter, because a lot of the times letters are presented in the introduction.
Yeah.
So that's when you say we want to marry your daughter, and that's when you bring your letter.
He'll come with like his family, and then like he's married them, and then she'll come with her family as well.
And the thing is, if you combine the cultural. If you combine the cultural aspects with the religious aspects, you can get kind of long, bruv.
Oh, bro.
Introduction, bro. And obviously, Nikah in Islam, then the wedding reception, all that stuff.
Mm. Oh, my God.
The trad, it's all.
And the thing, like the trad normally, it would, you can probably combine that with, I think you do the trad.
But yeah,
the
listen.
The trad would be like,
I'm combining.
They call it, they call it the engagement as well, if you like.
I ain't doing it.
Yeah.
I ain't doing the introduction, and a kai, a trad, and a wedding. Nah, are you crazy, man?
Yeah, but you don't have to. But the introduction doesn't have to be anything big. The introduction just everyone comes to the family. You have little chin chin, little drinks.
Like literally, you bring soft alcohol,
drink and, soft drink and biscuits.
You like Muslim, innit? So, bruv, we accept schnapps and proper.
Schlur in our household.
They bring you hardcore alcohol that gives you hair on your balls, bruv. I'm not even joking.
What? Armor of God.
Have you ever drank a petashi?
Yeah, in Ghana.
Fam, it's not.
We'll go.
It's not. No. I don't.
Republic.
I'm
all right. We'll go and have a good time.
Nah, I don't want hairs.
And
on
then
my
we're
chest.
Gonna do five fingers.
I don't want hairs on
we're
my chest.
We're gonna do five fingers.
No, reveals the price.
But yeah, so there is a difference between a trad and a white wedding. But culturally,
white wedding is what we need to say the word, because actually a trad in Africa is seen as the wedding, right? Yeah. So we have to differentiate.
So the thing is, when
wedding.
You do a trad over here, like legally, it's not seen as a legal something that's legally binding,
right?
Yeah, but over there,
because they recognize traditional customs and cultures.
So that's why most people here, if you do a trad and you don't do a white wedding, you just go registry and sign, and that's it. You're married.
But even some places, even if you do a white wedding, if that church isn't.
Yeah, you still have to go registry.
Yeah, so you some still people, have to go registry.
Not even just the church, the venue. If the venue hasn't got
or the priest isn't even ordained.
Yeah.
You have to go to a registry.
I remember my sister's engagement or trad and her wedding were, they were just so, it was ridiculous in terms of what they did. The trad itself could have been a wedding.
Yeah.
Because it was so, like, I forgot where it was in Lagos.
So big.
But it was huge. Like, my mum actually booked this massive like hall / field. I thought, I was so confused, I thought that was the wedding until because it was, I didn't understand why it was so big until literally 2 days later when they actually had the wedding. I was like, but didn't we just get married the other day? Because it was so big.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
It was so,
I thought we was already married.
We not legal,
like it was like there's an actual I don't know where she keeps it now. I think there's some albums in my mum, with my mum, and there's some albums with my sister, but there's two separate sets of albums, literally one for the trad and one for the wedding. But each one, like literally the stack is like this.
Yeah.
It is ridiculous. Yeah. Like,
so but Africans register and recognize trads more, isn't it?
Because
culturally it's what you're meant to do. It's a custom. So they don't, that's why they kind of, parents over here are a bit in their feelings if you don't want to do it, because it's you can't neglect your culture, innit? So that's why I feel like a lot of our generation now are doing both.
Yeah.
And some are only, I know people that have only had trads, and their trads, for Lucy's, his trad was so big, there's no way he could have had a wedding afterwards.
He's married.
Lucy's been married for years.
Four years.
No, he's married. His wedding was, that's what, he got married early.
Okay.
And his wedding was even the biggest trad I've been to neither.
His trad was massive.
Oh, I don't know.
And it couldn't, like, there's no way. I was like, wedding, he was like, never. Like, there was like, I swear there's like 800 people.
To be
there.
Fair, I would do that and then just do a destination thing.
Yeah, it was mad. Yeah. It was huge.
I don't know, like, when I eventually tied or not, I don't know what I'm going to do. Man,
say,
why?
Why you?
Starting to my throat.
I got something I want to say, big
man. Starting to my throat.
No, I've got something I want
to
say.
Leave him, he's
you
laughing.
Belong to the streets!
I know you don't.
Who, Dami?
Yeah, I definitely...
Don't let the PlayStation pad pull it through.
Oh.
Don't let the... What's it called? The party room. Don't let the party room fool you. This nigga belongs to the streets.
The streets.
When I eventually turn up, I don't think the traditional stuff, I don't do any of that. I'll compromise, definitely.
You want to give your mama a heart attack?
No, she'll be fine, man. Mm-hmm. She'll be fine. Man.
Really?
Yeah, she'll be fine.
You're Nigerian.
Yeah, I know. And and considering what she did with my sister, so I know she's gonna want to do the biggest thing because I'm the last one in that.
I was literally about to say,
but it's not happening.
Who's gonna get married first? You, Fatima, or Idris?
That's a very good question. I mean, only one person right now is in the driver's seat, innit? But I put
the first name that you mentioned.
Yeah, Idris.
Yeah, he's in the driver's seat. But I.
Yeah, well, yeah, well, he should be because yeah, he's
but I couldn't tell you when that's gonna happen, innit? But with me, it could happen next week. You know what I mean? I told you, bro.
Do them quick.
Okay.
Do them quick things.
Listen.
We met 3 hours ago. I'm in love.
Honestly,
Dami, you are gas, bro. But it could happen next week.
It could happen next week, man. He doesn't have faith in me. I messaged you, Dami. I said, you should listen, yeah? It's going to happen when you least expect it. All you're going to get is a wedding invite.
No, I pray it does happen, but I don't believe it's going to happen soon.
Listen, don't worry about me.
No, I'm getting off base of what you've told me, innit? Yeah. So there's nothing you told me that's pointing towards a wedding now.
How old are you now, Dami?
I was 13 August.
Streets. Oh, okay. You belong to streets.
I'm saying, because it's married at 30.
Oh, my God.
35-ish. It's married and kids at 30.
I saw that post the other day, actually. Someone was like, yeah, I think it was 25 was the original. No, 30 was the age. And
he's
was
looking
like,
at 35.
Looking a bit. No, I think that's the one I saw was like 40-ish. Looking at 40-ish.
No respect.
Nah, mine's, yeah.
Fam, for some of us in this room, is looking a bit 40-ish.
Oh, yeah.
Brent.
You're bad.
Is that why you're not trying to go affirmation?
Demons.
Hey, me? What, in Ghana, you mean?
Portugal.
Listen, I told everyone, bruv. I'm an uncle, innit? Uncle shouldn't be in Afro Nation. Anyone seen The Irishman?
Yes. No.
It's long though, isn't it? Was it you that was it's taking you 3 days to watch it?
Man's watching like a series.
Not
45 minute increments.
That's exactly
it's
why.
It's 3 hours long.
No, that's
no,
exactly
three and a half hours.
Yeah, it's 3.5 hours. But that's exactly why I went to cinema to watch it.
One girl.
When did it come out?
Cinema and Netflix.
Look, so basically, they did a limited release in it kind of thing. But I think it's still in cinemas now.
Fucking fantastic.
But I had, because I was like, there's no way.
You know, I'm going to have to watch it in the cinema. Yeah. Someone like me.
But you can't.
Short attention span.
It's not about like, it's not in Odeon. It ain't like Endgame. Yeah. It's not like there's 3 hours of action.
Oh, is it? Yeah.
The film is, the film drags. It's good.
Nah,
but it's too long.
I think it's amazing.
That means there's a lot of scenes that could be cut.
No, I would.
Let's be honest.
Do you know what it is? Maybe it's because I watched it all in one go, like power, and I enjoyed it. This is what I'm saying. I watched it all in one go. I didn't fall asleep once. It was. That's why I feel films like that have to be experienced in a cinema.
And that's what I'm saying. Films. I need food.
Yeah, like
one girl
told me
today
home?
On Twitter.
No, because I have my phone.
She watched it twice. She watched it twice.
7 hours.
Big man, she said she watched it twice because she's really into mafia movies.
Yeah, when you go, I'm actually glad the way they released it because you're not gonna get to go and sit in like a. In an Odeon or Cineworld and get to enjoy it properly, kind of thing. You have to go to like, you know, like an Everyman's or like
Is it a Netflix original?
Ritzy, yeah, no, it was.
It isn't it? Huh? Isn't it? So Ritzy, they released it with Netflix. But
it's one of the stations.
Fantastic.
But it's so where I went to Oldgate, to the cinema in Oldgate to watch it. And
did you just say Oldgate?
Yeah. Where's that?
Sorry, you just pronounced every single.
So how's that supposed to be pronounced?
Oldgate.
I thought you were talking about a different place.
Thank you. He said, I went to Oldgate.
I was thinking, where's Oldgate?
You're like the pronunciation and grammar police.
No, I'm really not. No,
it's not Oldgate. It's Oldgate. It's spelled A-L.
Yeah.
It's not old as in
Oldgate.
O-L.
I know, but it's just the way I say it.
To be honest with you, I just had to be sure. That's why.
No, I'm thinking, where's Oldgate?
That's why I thought.
See, in my head, when you said Oldgate, that sounds normal to me. So
when he said Oldgate, I was thinking, no, he couldn't be talking about Oldgate. He couldn't.
Oldgate East.
So I'm sure you guys have been to like those nice little luxury cinemas where they got like the big seats. And everything.
I've been to Everyman still.
Do you know what I mean? And that's generally a film like that, that's how you got to experience it.
Really?
Like,
where you've got the comfy chairs, you can get all food.
Of that. And I go cinema on my ones pretty much 9 out of 10 anyway.
Same as me.
But I enjoyed it this much more on my ones because there was literally hardly anyone sitting next to me. Cinema was packed, but like on my road, there's no one there kind of thing. So I can like proper like stretch out onto the couch. I was like laughing on my ones. Like it was just...
At what?
Bro, there was so much funny stuff in that film.
In what movie?
Yeah. Okay, you know what? Maybe my sense of humor is dark, innit? But I actually laugh at a lot of the deaths in it. Like to me, they're funny, innit?
Exactly. So, no. Okay, well, because I don't want to do spoiler.
Yeah.
But the way he was killing, man, was always weird. It's like, I know. It's like, man couldn't handle the gun, bruv.
The recoil fucked him up.
No, the way De Niro was popping, man, it was just weird.
No, some of the slappings were too much, man. That there was, no spoilers in it, but there was one year.
Like, everyone knows the film's for the killings. That's not a spoiler.
The guy was mid-sentence, so I'm just like,
but it was only me. The way he handled the gun and his whole approach, even awkward. The way he shot him, everyone was weird. Cool,
but that was part of the point in the film as well, because he didn't want to do any of that. So that's it came out in the way that he done it.
Bro, he was shooting them with Tourette's, bro. Like,
I'm sorry.
It was just weird. I thought, did they train him how to hold the gun properly? Because this is just weird.
But he was old as well. Like, yeah. It's all of that too. But no, honestly speaking, it's one of those films, go cinema, like proper, like plan your day around it so that you're refreshed and just so you can really watch it and enjoy it. Because it's a wicked film. It's probably the best one I've seen this year, to be honest, I think.
The funny thing is, Endgame is around the same time. And you don't have to give people this speech for Endgame.
Endgame is different. Endgame is
exactly. It's because the film is very, it's a somber movie.
Yeah, it's slow paced, but I think it's just great, man.
Someone like me who has a very short attention span.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, you're gonna pick up on one or two characters, you're gonna be invested in them. Like, you're gonna get attached
to them. But that's why I know I can't watch it at home.
Yeah.
Jimmy Hoffa.
Because if you're telling me it's 3.5 hours.
Yeah.
The moment I
didn't feel like it though. The first hour went by for me pretty quickly as well. So
Jimmy Hoffa, but yeah, decent film. Robert De Niro, Al Pacino, Joe Pesci,
Ray Romano.
But you know his brother from the Ray, Everyone Loves Raymond.
Yeah,
he's in it as well. But but they put prosthetics to make him look older, innit?
Oh yeah. And there's a cameo from someone else as well that I loved.
Yeah,
don't say it.
Why?
Don't be a spoiler.
Yeah. They don't even know who he is.
Are you sure?
How do you know?
Exactly.
Do you know who Action Bronson is?
No.
Okay.
I knew it.
Fair enough.
You ain't into hip hop.
Yeah, but that got me though. But that was funny, man. That got me.
Who else is in it as well? There's one more person. There's
that girl that was what was her name? She was Rogue in X-Men.
Is she in it? Where? I don't know.
His daughter when she's older.
Oh, Peggy.
Yeah.
But when Peggy was younger, she was a brunette. And she's blonde.
She dyed her hair in it.
Oh, that's what confused me. I thought, yeah. Is this a different daughter?
No. And you can always tell because of her facial expressions.
Yeah,
always...
no, you could tell because of the narrative.
Yeah.
That she loves Jimmy and hates her dad. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I thought, why is her hair blonde? But yeah, that's our spoiler-free Irishman.
Yeah, go see it, man. It's
bad, conversation.
Bad boy film.
It's a real nigga's birthday.
Who?
Jigga, Jay-Z.
Oh yeah. Oh, I spent this morning.
I know. I saw it. Spent the whole day talking about Nas.
Jigga,
all the music's available on Spotify.
That will be gone next week, though.
The thing is, all these albums were already on iTunes, apart from one. Apart
yeah,
from,
to purchase, but if you stream them,
free.
Yeah, to purchase, but people like me that
no,
use Spotify,
they're already on Apple Music to stream.
No, they
yes,
weren't.
Yes, they was.
No, they weren't.
Crystal, I have Apple Music. I've been blasting Jay-Z for the.
No, did you buy it?
No, streamed it off Apple Music, 100%.
Which albums? Reasonable Doubt.
All these albums here, apart from Blueprint 3.
Let me see.
Big man, they've been there. Apple Music.
Oh, they've been there for a while.
It's for time, man. I remember the day they released Blueprint 2 on there, I was excited. And that was months ago.
Yeah, but I'm saying he's recently started doing it, but for years they weren't.
Yeah, for years.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm talking about this year.
Yeah, oh, get out of here, man. Fuck
I'm talking
off.
About this year.
Yeah, because he's Friend. Recently been slow dripping.
Yeah, I know. Me. But the Spotify thing Tap only happened you. Today.
Yeah, and that's why everyone's excited.
Yeah.
Because obviously Reasonable Doubt was nowhere. The only place you could listen
know,
to it was on YouTube.
Yeah. But I'm really annoyed that Blueprint 3 is not on there because there's one song that I need off that.
Same, the Cardi one.
No, mine's the Jeezy one.
Oh, yeah.
Epic still. All right, no one cares about Jay-Z's birthday, it's fine. It's
happy birthday to Jay-Z.
Happy birthday.
Anyone seen the
thank you.
The Fab versus Shiggy situation?
You know what, yeah?
What happened?
I'm not going to lie. This is the problem. Like, it annoyed me. So basically, yeah, you know how Shiggy obviously did the whole Drake
Kiki.
Challenge, the Kiki challenge, and it went viral and whatnot. Mad, and basically, because of that, they shot a video for the song and it was just charting on the Billboard. So essentially, he made the song go viral, he made it blow. And yeah. Someone was even saying Drake wasn't even meant to release, it wasn't even meant to be released at all.
As a single.
As
yeah.
a single, but it's just because it got so much hype.
It got so much traction.
Yeah. So they've got that Choosy. Is that Choosy?
That song,
no.
That song's
choosy,
right, yeah.
Choosy, 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 choosy.
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 Yeah.
I don't wanna choose.
There you go.
Yeah.
Fabulous.
So, fun fact, I cleared
it. Davido's in that, innit?
Davido
and... I cleared it for Columbia.
Okay.
You cleared it?
We heard you.
Got insider, yeah?
Bang, bang.
Say come no. on. Right, so they've asked Shiggy. So him and Casanova asked Shiggy to do a challenge for the song.
To do what to that song?
A little dance, innit?
A dance.
Basically, the Juicy Challenge is you and your partner just vibes together.
Oh,
choosy.
This is the Fab song, yeah?
What kind of shit challenge is that, bro?
Like, I choose you, and we're just going to vibes.
No, that's a shit challenge, bro.
That's it.
Anyway, they've asked Shiggy to do a challenge. Mm-hmm. And obviously, he's like, yeah, cool, you're going to have to drop a couple racks for that.
Because apparently Drake did
drop them bands, cuz.
Even if they didn't, they're like, not mocking him, but like, yeah, how are we gonna pay you? Yeah. Like, I've retweeted, like, I've reposted some of your stuff before. I put you on.
That's nice.
You didn't put me on.
Cool story, bro.
You didn't put me on because I was doing what I was
doing.
Don't
think they said they put him on.
He did say something like that.
He says, well, Casanova said, oh, when you niggas are in the club, we bring you lot in our section, we give you like bottles, da da da.
So?
And this is still business.
No, that was Casanova's like justification.
But doesn't, but I'm sure Fab said something about,
where was this?
I repost.
This is at Fab's. He had like a little launch event for his album.
I've reposted you a few times, like to kind of like show off your stuff. So kind of do it as a favor. But I thought, no. At the end of the day, this is the problem with black people. You want to claim to support black people.
Mm. You've seen, man.
You've seen what, like,
right, that's his business,
you, there's
huh?
a reason why you want him to do a challenge to your yeah. song.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know how big it could be. You've seen what he's done with mm-hmm. somebody else. So you want his services, no?
Yep.
Are you Fabulous and Casanova? Are you performing for free? Just out of curiosity.
Not a single one of those people.
Are you performing for free?
No.
So my friend, keep your mouth closed.
Yeah, business is business.
I mean, that his business is funny because I just think the way he goes around dancing and stuff is so funny to me. He actually just looks like a moron most
times. Shiggy, yeah,
he does. Like, have you guys
seen? No, even when
have
he
seen
did
that meme? Have you seen the meme of him when he's at an NBA game and the camera pans him and for no reason
he just starts
dancing for no reason.
Yeah, that's what he's thinking.
And then someone must have taken the video and actually put like a caption over it. They were putting like names of people that are in the crowd and. It came to him. He didn't put his name. They just put nigger boy.
Oh, shit.
Ouch.
Yeah.
And it's just him just dancing.
But that's his brand though, isn't it? And obviously he's worked. He's worked. Yeah, but that's it.
Why are you calling him jackass? What's going on?
And to be fair, and to be frank, listen, as a black man.
I like Shiggy.
You, as a black man, I think there's even some certain level of shame that you have to put down to be like, this is what I'm going to do.
Okay, yeah, no, I hear
to
that.
To dance and do whatever. So it's true. You can't come and tell me to do a challenge.
Yeah, but look at the way you're talking
free.
About him.
Yeah.
It's degrading.
Yeah, it's degrading.
No, but that's the
and
thing.
And he knows that he has to do that.
Don't reduce his experience.
That's his business. That's how he's making his money. Cool, fair enough.
Mm.
I'm not even knocking him for it. I just think he looks stupid.
No, I know you're not, but I'm saying, like, imagine him as a black man.
Oh, of course. Shit.
Knowing that this is the public image that I have to put out here,
yeah.
And people are gonna call me a fool. People are gonna call me this. People are gonna,
so not gonna pay for it. Yeah,
at least
shit,
like, for that shit. Like,
I definitely think like there's no way that they should be asking him to do it for free or whatever, or saying, oh yeah, we'll give you clout or this whatever.
Yeah,
we'll bring
he doesn't
it. Like,
need it.
That's, he doesn't need it. Listen,
yeah.
Pay him.
Man, like, mm. I need like, the coins.
He's like, let's be honest, he's making a fool of himself for
yeah,
money.
Yeah, for
so,
money.
So pay him for it.
I don't really think he's making a fool of himself. I don't see it this way.
No, I do.
No, he does look a bit ridiculous.
No,
he's
I just see it as that's his brand, and it's not for me to judge. Judge how like how he yeah. wants to make his coins. Like,
no, I'm not judging about how he makes his coins. I'm just saying in terms of how
it looks stupid.
The
like,
videos
I'm not,
look
I don't,
at
I'm not
times
him,
they do
it
look a bit. They do look
does.
A bit.
What you
moronic.
Mean? Just his normal videos or
but
you mean when he does?
But he's entertaining
he
though.
No, his normal videos. No, some of his videos are funny.
He's an entertainer though, no?
Yeah, I'm saying he's an entertainer. So I don't see how he.
I'm not trying to mock. Yeah, I'm not trying to mock.
Because you think he can't dance?
No, not because he can't dance.
No, it's just the image.
So if Omarion was. Dancing.
No, but we all after Omarion when he was dancing in South Africa
dance,
too, though.
Nah.
No, but Shiggy dances in his own way. He's not an Omarion dancer,
yeah.
but he's
yeah.
a but
I'm saying,
pop shit,
looks,
funny type dancer.
It's like, look at how everyone loves a safari.
The thing is, I don't love safari.
Listen,
I love it.
Wait. At his own baby shower. Yeah. This nigga dressed up as Michael Jackson
wait,
in the
he,
Smooth
wait,
Criminal video.
Did you see when he stepped up?
He put a plank of wood on the floor with attachments.
Yeah.
Put his feet, he placed his feet on the attachments and man doesn't lean. I thought this nigga went all out.
Which,
I love.
You know
can I be honest with you?
It's ridiculous,
guys.
Man.
I freaking love safari.
Fam,
do you know what is the worst one for safari?
All out, bro.
Do you know the
him?
Worst one for
he's
safari?
Ridiculous,
yeah?
Man.
Is the BT experience.
What, when Nicki Minaj?
And I don't sympathize.
That's my nigga.
In the background, your mother.
That's my nigga.
And he just popped locked and dropped it.
Yeah, mother. No, Safari's my nigga.
No. He's funny.
And to this day, that's why I always remember, because I don't sympathize, because you were a simple bitch. And I just remember Safari was
popping. Wait, what's it? A dum-dum. A tongue-tongue. A fun-fun. A tongue-tongue. Chun-chun. Chun-chun. I was like, this nigga is going ham in a t-shirt and a hat.
So funny, man. I don't know how you can straight face.
And Nicki, they're like, simple. And then people. And a dundun, and a sunshine, and a sunshine. I thought, what type of bars are these?
Brett, please do a favor and put that in the YouTube.
No, I can find it.
In the YouTube footage.
No, I can find it.
No, how does he keep a straight face?
No, I'm gonna find that clip.
Like, I don't get it. Like.
No, but guys, you know what?
I'm even sweating, bro.
I could be with someone like Safari.
I'm even sweating right now.
Because, because he's
in
know
public,
me, yeah?
Doing that in public.
No, but you know me, I'm very easily amused. So our relationship will be lit because
yeah, but in public,
I was
doing that in public.
I was that. I'll have to
wait, guys, please. Laugh at me. Let's not play. Oh shit.
I'm dead. Let me see. The
bandan.
No, look at him.
Let me see.
In the red light.
In the red light.
Another performance where they're outside. That's the one. Because it's more of an intimate stage. The stage is small, so he doesn't So you don't have. You see how with this one, he's getting
I
to travel.
I'm sweating right now because I'm.
Wait, Gina, how can you say he's getting to travel?
He doesn't travel. No, in that one, he's probably traveling from one side of the stage to the other. In the BT one, he's there. He's
a
fixture. He's a fixture. So like all eyes on him. It's jokes.
Simple.
Do you know what it looks like? Do you know on stage when we got people performing, you got the people doing the sign language for the deaf people?
That's how he looked.
Yeah.
See, this guy's taken too far with
But back to Shiggy, yes. So
no,
I get it. If I'm gonna have to be doing this in public, pay me my money.
You know, he has to get paid. I think
definitely
Shiggy needs to understand here. Casanova and Fabulous and all these other artists are not his friends.
Yeah.
They're just industry friends, industry associates, and they're gonna want you to do things for free because they're looking at you like, nigga, you're beneath me.
That's exactly the point. Why am I going to pay you a clown? Like, you a buster. Yeah. Like,
exactly. That's exactly the point.
It's a respect thing, isn't it?
Yeah, I've taken on this moronic public image. So you might as well pay me for it.
See, the way you guys are degrading, that's moronic.
It is a bit, fucking hate
Wait, so give the same energy to all the other people who just dance on Instagram.
Of course.
Yeah, I do.
Of course.
My man, Shiggy. Shigster.
Do you know how bad it is that I don't even understand why people have dances at concerts? Like, it really irritates me.
Right.
Because of
I don't know, I just don't like it.
You gotta have Safari
I think it depends though. Fucking irritates me.
It adds entertainment and stage presence, especially if you're dancing with your dancers and you are doing something lit.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's a bit, I don't know.
I haven't done dancers,
it adds stage value. I just don't like it. I don't know, I just find it
something to look at. It's like a physical spectacle, isn't it?
I get it. No, I get all the reasons why. I just don't personally like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, I think the narrative people put out there was, well, the question was, should you pay your friends for business transactions, or should your friends ask for money?
Of course, you should pay your friends for business.
Should you do things for free because of friendship?
No,
that was the whole
thing. How's your friend supposed to eat?
That's what I'm saying.
This is the thing. You would never go to work for free. So why should your friends?
Yeah, bruv, never.
That's what I don't understand.
These people don't even go to clubs for free half of the time. Like, so why am I going to post?
I'm ready for the turn up.
Like, you get paid to do appearances just to sit at a club.
Turn up to a club. And sometimes, like, they won't even know that you're coming, but the minute that you're there, your personal assistant will go in, negotiate whatever rate that they want to negotiate, and then you walk into the club. So why am I going to do this for free and then promote it? And then I'm seeing all my things going viral and I didn't get anything from it.
Nah,
because the thing is, you want me to do that video because you want monetary gain.
Obviously,
so you want your song to blow, monetary gain, and I don't make anything out of it.
Nah.
Even if you're not going to pay me, like, like a proper fee at the beginning. Give me some back end and be like, okay, I'm going to give you 2% or 3% of whatever we make on the track. Fine, but you're planning to make money. Yeah, you're planning to make money and I'm not going to make money. Bruv, that's the biggest foolery, tomfoolery I've ever heard.
What's it called? Do you think, you know, in America, like people walking through clubs, like artists, it's kind of a big thing. You reckon that could ever pop here?
I think people are too familiar. I think we're too familiar.
Yeah, we are. I'm not going to lie. We don't rate each other.
Because who would you do it for? Who would you do it for?
I'm ready for the walkthrough bag, cuz.
You know the only... No, we don't. The only one... Anthony Joshua.
Yeah.
And I think girls would lose their mind. I would even lose my mind.
You know what's so funny? In the white community, it's kind of more.
Yeah, they still do it.
So like they'll love you
for making money.
So for example, KSI turning up to a club, like somewhere, like I don't know, in Norwich.
It's so funny you're talking about white people, but we're referencing a black man. Sorry, I get it.
That's just the market.
No, I know.
KSI walk through a club in Norwich, and they will pay him because they know people go to.
The key thing there is Norwich. These things are happening in London.
No, I think in London he would as well. For white people,
No, it could happen in
Reading. Southampton.
No, I think in London for the white people crowd.
Bristol.
Exactly. Yeah. Particular markets, like if you get all the uni markets in these cities, they're gonna lap it up.
Yeah. No, I think white people in London would do it.
Some of them would though. Some of them would.
It's just the market. It's just white people is your market.
Out of London kind of thing. So it does happen over here.
No, I disagree because Love Island people are doing walk-ins in London.
That's true.
Love Island people doing walk, like, do you know what I mean?
They
Ovi and Man, them,
like, like when Jack Fowler Jack and them make, they get paid to
do it in London. When they're doing Sugar Hut or whatever it's bloody called, like, they're making money.
Yeah, no, it's true.
It's just that we're too familiar because it's like, am I paying to see this person have fun in the club?
Yeah.
It's not even that, though. I feel like we're too familiar in the sense where, like, everyone has access to everyone now. Mm. It's not special to see a celeb.
Because even your fave, Bria, it's like, I could see her in an Afrobeat party and she'll be there. Yeah. So why am I going to pay to go to a club to party with her?
Yeah.
I would never pay to party with anyone, to be honest.
Yeah, I just, no.
That's just me.
Yeah, like, generally speaking.
And how, you're not even partying with the person.
They're over there.
They're in VIP.
Like, people will promote their night out saying, okay, this person's going to be here kind of thing. People were going to go regardless if that person was
So you've just lost money. You've just lost money as a club person.
Yeah, I think I wouldn't use that person as like a, oh my gosh, come and see this person because that's hella cringe. But obviously if they're there, they're there, innit?
Yeah.
But in America, literally, it's, oh my gosh, Fab's going to be at this club. We need to go.
Bruv.
No, I know. Yeah,
I remember Miami, 2011, and we're trying to get into Live. And literally, they hadn't even announced anyone. They hadn't announced anyone was coming, nothing. So you get there, and they're like, okay, $50, whatever, normal. Yeah. And then you just hear, oh, Lil Wayne's coming. All right, cool, $300. I'm like, what? Just because you've now heard that Lil Wayne is coming.
Beverly reminded me of the club. That's Night Ladies. Okay. She remembers the name. But you know she went the year after.
Was it like cameos? Yes.
And she was like, the same thing happened.
Story.
But listen to this. Basically, it was her, Elizabeth, Bianca. Bianca's mixed race. And she was like, the bouncer literally was like, Bianca was like, yeah, you come in for free.
I swear.
And said the others had to pay.
Oh, wow.
That sounds like FM in a crowd, bro.
Black skin
sounds like FM, fam. When FM would say, Charlie, you can come, but your friend, dear.
What's that twist?
Yeah, your friend, dear. He didn't try. And then FM would be like, yeah, you can come. And like, but brother, I came with free and my friend, they can't come in. And then you know when you go to your friend, I'm going to go in and see if the club is lit, yeah?
See, I wouldn't do that though. I would never leave my friend.
Well, leave your friend now. Back in the day, but I'm going to go in and see if it's lit. If it's lit, I'm going to try to see if I can pattern it. If not, let's go.
It's different for guys, man. Like, I don't think, anyway, I don't go out like that. But yeah, I don't think none of the men would leave each other.
I wouldn't leave you. You're a shit friend, bruv.
Yes, I am.
Listen, I'm saying, look.
Yes, I am.
I said, big man. It's about
I'm going in to look at if we're missing anything and then I'll come back out.
No, I don't think. I think the man don't really leave each other.
No, I wouldn't even do that.
Man don't leave each other.
You're going to go inside and it's lit. And I know for sure you're not coming out straight away. And I'm back calling your phone. Where are you?
These times
you buck someone on a table and you're like, they bought you a drink. And you're going to be like, oh yeah, my friend's outside. Nah,
I'm enjoying.
I think the man then would under certain circumstances.
Yeah, because so the thing about Twisted, if you go in and you find Eric, he will tell FM to let your friends in.
Let's just say there's 10 man then, 5 can get in, 5 can't. The five will just go and leave the other 5 to go.
Yeah, but that's different.
If it's one man them left by himself, that's different. Then that's when they have to leave, isn't it? You can't let this, the one guy just...
No, because sometimes you can pattern it. Like, if you see the promoters, your friends are...
But to be fair, I'm that guy who's going to be... You know what? You guys go.
Yeah, I'm going home.
I ain't going to ruin the party because I can't get in.
I'm exactly the same.
No, but I am. But I'm not going to lie if my bedroom leaves me.
I'm looking for...
No, but do you know what's the worst?
When you get back to that hotel...
No, but do you know what's the worst?
No, on a holiday.
Oh, no, no, holiday is different. Yeah.
You're talking about Ghana, bro. Is that in this country?
Oh, but I used to live there now. So sometimes just Friday. But sometimes there's a problem.
On holiday, it's not that bad because there's so many other things to do.
It's true.
But you know what's the problem? When your friend knew the fucking dress code, yeah? You done told them the dress code.
Okay, that's different.
And then they still don't stick to the dress code. And when you get there, they're now looking at you. Bruv, I told you the dress code.
No, fair enough. That one's different.
Now you're looking at me like Mumu.
That one, dear, I can't help you.
Bruv, you better sit in that taxi until I finish my enjoyments because I wore my heels.
I got shoes in the car.
Mate.
Offset is
what's going on with that one?
Apparently he got hacked. Twitter got hacked, but he sent a DM
on Insta
to 6ix9ine, Tekashi 6ix9ine's girlfriend,
And her and Cardi are ops basically, isn't it?
Apparently her and Cardi have a pending court case or something. I don't know.
The strippers that she got beaten up?
I think so. The stripper that she whatever it was.
How can he sort of miss you for real? Like what
hold on, who exposed him?
I don't know. It might have been her. It was her.
The club is called Sobe Live. I actually remember it now. She was like, it's on 14th, I think, next to Miami Inc.
14th from Broadway.
The fact that she even remembers this, so weirdo.
So, I think she put out the tweets. I didn't read the tweets. Did you read the tweets?
I just saw the video and then I saw like the screenshot of him pretending to be hacked on Twitter and the screenshot of what he sent her basically.
Okay.
So he DM'd her on Insta.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But claimed that he got hacked on Twitter.
Yeah. And then he's got all these random tweets on Twitter, like to make it seem like he got hacked.
Yeah.
Like, hey, I like ass
or Alec balls.
Alec balls. Fuck Cardi B. Everyone's like shit like that. I've been hacked. Yeah. But I think there's a video of her being like, oh no, guys, Offset got hacked. He's right here.
He does a lot of dumb shit. We know he does a lot of dumb shit, but you know, it's not one of these. I'm thinking like, you are so naive.
Bitches always make excuses for a trifling nigga.
Do you know
the thing is, my whole
thing. You don't think it's true?
My whole thing is this.
He got hacked.
Again? Yeah. Nigga, you're cheating again. Like, how many times is she going to take you back?
Y'all won.
Yeah. I lied?
Yeah.
Where'd we won?
Y'all won.
He's a clown though, man. Seriously.
So,
I just love the use of the word weird.
Oh. So that's my thing. Yeah. I believe that obviously he did DM her.
Of course.
And my whole thing is, you're still on this.
Yeah.
With someone that...
And you're so famous that people are waiting to make a story out of you.
I feel like that's the thing where it's in your bloodline.
Yeah.
Like you're a serial cheater. You can't help it.
But this is but the problem isn't even about serial cheating as well. The problem is look at their circumstance. How old is he? How old is her?
They're younger.
How serious were their situation?
Mid-20s now.
She's at 25. Yeah. He's at 28 or whatever.
Yeah.
Mm. How serious were you guys before?
He's
you decided,
got five baby moms.
Do you know what I mean? It's like look at the circumstance of the person that you're dealing with.
A lot of these men need vasectomies, man, because it's ridiculous stuff. A lot of them need vasectomies.
Bruv, look at the man that you're dealing with before. You even start trying to think
but
that
the thing is,
he's not going to stop cheating on
what's
you.
Worse is on it's about who he's messaging. He's messaging someone who has beef with his ties with her, which is extremely weird. Like, he's not
your thing's dead, dummy.
But that is so funny that you think getting hacked on Twitter means that you got hacked on Insta.
That's the whole narrative.
It's clever, stupid.
Well, at least he had something, a way to come out of it, boy.
Yo,
well, either way, even if he did do it, she'll take him back anyway. So all this, I got hacked, is a waste of everybody's time. And it's just bloody, what's that word? You're insulting our intelligence as like a people. It's like, she was going to take it back anyway.
But that was like Princess and Ray J, though, when she was doing
Listen, Ray J can do no wrong in my eyes.
No, not him. I'm talking about her.
The king of R&B.
Bruv, he's fan of shit, though.
When she said that he abandoned her.
Ray J is untouchable.
He's
unfathomable, bro.
Infallible?
Infathomable. What were we going to say? No. Lori Harvey has moved on again,
bro. What, to Future?
To Future. What's going on
with
this
girl?
But
has it been proven that she moved off Future?
He gave her an AP, fam.
Bruv. He
gave her an AP.
He gave her an EP.
AP.
Oh, what does that mean?
All the more Piquet.
Yeah, but what does that mean for a person that's got money?
He claims
Drake gave Bernice Burgess a whole Rolls Royce.
No, but he claims that anyone that's wearing anyone's wearing an AP, that's dealing with him. That they're one of his basically.
No, basically, forget that. What I'm trying to say is this girl is how old?
22.
Fam,
she belongs to the streets.
Diddy, Future,
Diddy's son.
Trey Songz, Diddy's son.
Oh,
the footballer.
Memphis Depay.
Memphis Depay. But and God knows who else? More.
Mm-hmm. She belongs to the show. And these times, Steve Harvey's come to tell us, think like a lady, act like a man.
Bro, she studied. Like, she studied her dad's book, like a Bible, bro. And she's playing out.
No, because the book didn't say that though.
The book didn't say what?
No, the book wasn't saying the shit that she's saying.
She's learning off her mum more than anything.
No, so hold on.
No, I don't think she learned off her mum. The mum's been married.
The book's called what? Think like a.
Act like a. Was it? Think like a man. Think like a man. Act like a lady.
Act like a lady.
Think exactly.
Like a
man. That's what she's doing. She's thinking like a man, acting like a lady.
Nah, man.
She studied it cover to cover.
No, because the book ain't saying. The book is saying stuff like put him on a 90-day probation. Don't fuck him within 90 days. Yeah. Do that type of stuff.
It's not
like make sure he treats you nice.
Yeah.
Make sure he doesn't treat you as like a trip girl. Like all that.
She might be doing that, but still just bouncing around.
No, come on, man.
Fam, how can you date a father and son?
Son, but because you might be buff, but come on. It gets to a point.
She's
when
pretty,
like,
but she's not like.
She's gorgeous.
Yeah, she's gorgeous. Gorgeous.
No, she's gorgeous. Fucking gorgeous.
Mm-hmm.
But.
Yeah, it gets to a point when you're just like, what is going on here?
Yeah,
and then you have to start questioning someone's self-esteem. You have to really start questioning, like, how do you view yourself?
I'm not hating on anyone here, but like, women here, you got to look at it and think, you know exactly what type of person future is here.
Yeah,
like,
100%.
Exactly.
Like, what? And you know, I get it. No, actually, no. I said, like, I get it. Like, I get it. Women. Like are drawn sometimes to people that they look at and think, wow, everyone says this is that kind of thing. Let me see for myself.
Not all women,
but I know that. But some women. So I get it.
That's one of the reasons why. I remember he's famous. Remember, there's a lot of girls that want to come up.
But he's so like, is she?
I'm not talking about her in particular.
She's famous.
She's famous. She's not famous.
She's famous enough that she doesn't need to date future.
Mm, yeah.
Trust me. That when Laurie Harvey's on my wish, or was it my wish list?
I want Laurie Harvey on my wish list.
You don't need to start dating future.
Why? Because Meek said a bar about her.
Because what is dating future going to do for your notoriety as a person? You've already been in a song.
What's dating? Who cares about that Meek Mill song though?
The culture. So why would she date future?
I don't know, she likes him, isn't
it? No, I get it. So basically, if it's a come up thing.
Yeah, what come up thing?
I'm not saying she's dating for a come up.
Yeah. No, I when I said the come up thing, I'm talking about women in general, like women who will go up. Women. Yeah, normal average person.
But, you know what? I think a lot of time, like, we forget that like, Americans are genuinely wired differently to us.
Mm.
Like, they're wired like, think of it this year, like, how many people over here, if there was a guy like Future over here, like, of his like fame and like, you know, success and whatnot, and he had 7 baby mums. What famous kind of girl over here do you think that is probably might be on not on the same level as him, but is you know successful in her own right kind of thing, is gonna be attracted to him like that? Do you know what I mean?
You know what's weird as well?
Yeah,
it's America, it's so big over there, right? Yeah, and there's so much more of them over there.
They still fuck the same 10
than there is of us. Do you get what I mean? But they still all move in really small circles.
The same 10
chicks. It's weird.
And then they'll say stuff like, because you want to be with someone that has your same lifestyle, that understands you. It's like, that's bullshit.
Nah, but to be fair, they're fucking other chicks.
Yeah.
But they ain't put them chicks in front of the camera.
It's true.
That's the thing. Yeah, definitely.
They're parading around the same 10, 20 girls.
Yeah.
But they're all fucking millions of others.
And then those same 10, 20 girls is like, do you not see the image that you're being portrayed as? But even fucking Future. Like everybody else, like Trey Songz, I can understand. Future. Who just had a baby with somebody.
He's got like 7 baby mums.
Was he married to Sierra? Were they married?
No, they were engaged.
But do you know what's really funny? It's like,
supersonic.
I always think, like the world always views different people differently, right?
Mm. Mm.
So when Sierra went out with Future, what baby mother number was she?
I think she was 3 or 4 something.
Yeah, 3 or 4.
So already he's a collector before she got there.
A collector.
But I don't remember ever hearing any like, why would you go there kind of stuff. Because it's Sierra.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And even after they broke up, there was never a
accountability for her.
Like, you see how like, of course.
No, people did drag her though when she said that walk in the spirit of wife. Because people like, so were you working in that spirit with Future? Drag her for that.
But that was after. But I mean, she was with Russell, with her new guy, right?
Yeah.
But I'm talking about in the period. You see how we're quick to like, I just feel like everything Sierra does, prime example, there's videos of her like twerking and all this stuff on the camera.
Even I said, is it
like,
the spirit of the wife?
No, but like, you know how she's always kind of dance provocative?
Yeah.
Always, yeah. Even the ride video with Ludacris.
Mm.
That video was mad. Mm. But I've never...
Sorry to interrupt you. It's not the rival deal. It's the...
She the one... The
no.
No, the one on the track. And she's twerking no, no, on the no, truck.
No. Do you remember her
is
second...
It,
no.
Is it Whoa?
No.
Weep, weep,
guys,
weep.
No.
That's the song.
No, her second album. Remember the sing? The single was before
That's O,
I'm a Boy.
Oh, yeah.
No, the one where
the one you're singing is O.
No,
yes.
No, no. I'm gonna play it. Let me play it.
Yeah. That dog thing was fucking fantastic.
Let me play it. Talk and I'll find it.
I can give it.
But I think in her defense, and this is not to defend her, but
oh yeah, yeah.
Ride.
Oh
no, that's not right.
I think in her defense, I can do it up and down.
I think in her defense,
no, that's with no. Hold on, this one I'm talking about. Promise. Remember, promise.
Come and draw the line. Yeah.
This is when she first started dancing sexy. No?
I just wanna.
This video was a madness.
Yeah.
Remember Ride?
But this video, compared to Ride, yeah. Ride is much worse.
Them ones.
But in her defense, at that time, we didn't know a lot about Future's dating life.
No.
So we didn't know that he was.
That's not even what I'm talking about. I'm saying I feel like she's always kind of got a pass. You see how Sierra's always danced provocative?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm saying I've never really heard people say, oh, she's a bit skanky, she's ghetto, she's this, she's this, she's this. You see Cardi B twerk for Birkin and no one was, and everyone was, oh, she's ratchet, she's this.
Because of how she's built.
No, but I was going to say.
No, I don't think it is.
It is Crystal. I believe, that people that are slimmer and don't have a lot of junk in their trunk get away with a lot much
it's
more. And we degrade women who are packing. Like, I see all the time. Even when I went to fucking, and we spoke about this the other day, I went to fucking Thailand,
Language?
No, because we spoke about the other day and it pissed me off. I went to Thailand. And I was in shorts, denim shorts, and a body, but it was like a low backless body. I got sent
home. I know the one.
I got told I can't come in the club and I need to go home. Or no. I need to go and get a coat, And everyone was like, you're taking the piss. It's a nightclub. Like, I'm not just I'm not just inappropriately. Yeah. And she's showing too much skin. Okay. Was there not a girl standing two fingies in front of me in the tiniest of shorts? But because she's slim and petite, it doesn't look that.
I definitely agree with your point because I mean. But I think in terms of Sierra versus Cardi, I don't think that's the greatest comparison.
I'm not comparing.
The reason why people say that about Cardi is because that's Cardi's whole package and image.
Okay,
right?
Forget. I'm
being over salacious.
What I'm saying is, but Sierra's always been like that though.
Yeah, she does, but that's my point. Packages it differently.
But that's my point. I'm saying, forget the packaging. From early, you've been very performed before Cardi came out. Not even just her. You know Nicki Minaj. There's different women who've been sexy.
But you know what? Do you know what?
Little Kim. Like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, people said that she was provocative and Custer.
No, but do you know...
But Lil Kim's not skinny.
She was before she did all this.
Oh, I'm looking at her now.
Do you know what, funny enough, Sierra and Megan Thee Stallion, watching that video, I won't lie to you, I don't remember how Sierra danced. I was just watching Megan. And that's exactly what it is because, with me, I don't like super slim girls like that anyway. But... The thing is, look at it now. But
he
basically, it's because in my head, I'm not really looking at her in a sexual way kind of thing.
You're looking at her as a dancer.
Yeah, she's just she's just dancing. But with Meg, no, I'm looking at Meg because Meg is Meg.
And I agree. And I think that's the difference. So when you're comparing a Cardi to her, that is the comparison that you're making.
I get it.
Everyone looks at her as a dancer.
Obviously, I know Cardi and her are not the same. So, but I'm just giving an example of something that they both do and have done. Yeah. And if not Cardi, Nicki Minaj. If not Nicki Minaj.
But I feel you because I know I'm the same, and that same thing happened to me in Dubai. But you know me and you have these debates all the time when I'm like, but if I was a even about my Instagram, when people get on at me about my Instagram, that if I was a skinny person, you wouldn't care about the bikini pictures that I post.
It's true.
But it's because I'm thin that you're now coming to say, first chat. And I get it. We always have these conversations when back in the day, I'd be like, but Gina, what do you want me to do? I'm a thick girl and I'm in a bikini.
Facts.
A skinny girl would have. I definitely get your point. And I guess it's just because we are over sexualized as sicker women.
I agree.
But it's like, okay, if you show me two pictures of like a random, you know, like it's a random generic white person, white girl on
white person,
not white lady, should I say, on Instagram. She's like, she's in Australia or whatever, on the beach somewhere kind of thing. I'm going to see the bikini picture and just scroll past. I'm just going to scroll past. Yeah. But you get exactly what I mean.
Are you okay?
You're not respecting it.
But you get what I mean. But you
that's
get
somebody's
what I mean.
Wife.
I just swipe left. Yeah. I said, nothing to see here. Nothing to see here.
There's nothing to see then. That Jenny's, but if she's built a certain way, then I'm going to stay a bit longer.
But the white woman who are stacked.
She stacks the
Are you all right?
What?
You even like curved your spine.
The stackers. Listen, reduce.
But it's true. Like, subconsciously, we do it kind of thing. So Sierra's never going to be looked at that way.
Yeah.
She's just not. Like, Megan does the most regardless anyway.
She does the most.
It's true. You know who it is? Justin interrupt. You know who I've never looked at? Even though I've kind of liked Sierra a little bit throughout the years, I've always thought she was a bit cute.
No, she's nice.
But as a whole, her and Brandy,
yeah.
I've never really looked at them in a sexual way.
It's true.
To be fair.
It's just the reality.
What the fuck
of
did
it.
Brandy do for you to be looking at her? Have you seen her?
Wait, when
she was
in bed. That video looked
better. With the water. But that was when she was trying to be sexy.
That video looked bare awkward.
But that was her being sexy.
Like, stop forcing it, Brandy. Reduce it.
with the vest and the pant and the water.
Afro needs that, though.
Yeah, my Afro. I'm not going to lie, yeah. Song,
children are popping. It was forced. I'm like, you're trying to reinvent yourself sexy Brandy.
It's like Disney Child, yeah? You got Beyonce doing a nice dance on, and you see Michelle doing it. You're looking at Michelle like,
yeah,
oh, crack
yeah, that was wow.
I'm not gonna lie, yeah.
That was so deep.
I'm not involved in any Michelle slander.
No, I'm not slander.
I cannot reduce it. I cannot.
He said, I cannot reduce it.
It's when Michelle, you know what's the worst as well? On the homecoming one. When they ordered the twerk and then Michelle just goes, like,
nah, you know what?
No, stop!
Darling
is home time.
No, you know what it is?
But Michelle had the vocals.
No, because I think that people bully Michelle and I'm not here for it.
I'm not bullying her, but it's just.
I'm not here for it.
But I'm just making the point that she's slim in it. She's very slim in it. So it's like.
But at the same time, remember the last time when we were discussing, we were saying actually the biggest myth that was sold to us was that Beyonce was really thick.
She's not fit,
because she wasn't thick.
She's not thick at all. And I get it, but Beyonce is. Definitely thicker than Michelle.
Yeah, but the way that people have bullied Michelle on the basis of a myth as well, based on how Beyonce looked, is a bit unfair.
It is.
Yeah.
But
well, are we saying Beyonce's not packing? What are we saying?
No, I don't think Beyonce's packing.
Not packing.
Now she is.
No, she's
I think she wears a lot of corsets.
She's not an outie.
I think that's because she's wearing a lot of corsets.
No, I'm talking about throughout the years. Not talking about now.
No, I don't even think she's been that wide throughout the years.
Hasn't she been wide? No.
She definitely put on.
Look at her
because of the childbirth and whatnot. But
look at her pictures. She's never really been
childbirth.
Yeah.
Surrogate.
No, I'm not buying that because we was even discussing this at work. I had to repent for the fact that I believed that stupid rumor.
What do you mean? Might be into
it. No,
about her not carrying her baby.
The twins, I believe she carried, but Blue. Remember the video of the folding stomach?
Yeah, no, I do. But I remember watching an interview and I think it was her, Jay-Z was talking as well.
Yeah.
And just talking about the pain of like their miscarriages before.
Yeah.
And I was like,
do
you know what? We were cruel.
Oh no, if she done a surrogacy because of the miscarriages before, that's fair.
No, just the way that people say, nah, you didn't carry that baby.
It's trying to dupe the public with the fake prosthetic stomach, if that was even the case.
Yeah,
you were doing so well.
If because we all seen the video, right? She sat down and it scrunched in.
Yeah, that video was like, oh, Beyonce. Huh?
Beyonce. What's going on here, Beyonce?
Sorry, how did we get? We're still talking about Lori Harvey.
How did we get to Beyonce?
Yeah, segue.
That was a mad segue. Sure.
Lori is really pretty, though.
She's very gorgeous.
But she's moving mad.
But you know what? It's so funny. My boy was showing me, every time like a story about her came up here, like maybe like a day or two later, Depay would post something on Insta with like a random caption of him like looking so, and I kind of don't get it.
Imagine this.
Who's fiance?
Memphis Depay, Depay, whatever.
He's a footballer.
Yeah. Imagine you're engaged to this woman. Beautiful
engaged.
Woman, Lori Harvey.
And that's
engaged.
When she was popular. Like, that's when she started becoming popular.
This is when she was like
19 or 20.
She wasn't really in the public eye. Yeah. People knew who she was, but she wasn't famous. Imagine now you broke up with her, whatever, and you're seeing her go from man to man. Yeah. Are you gonna feel? You're gonna feel. What emotion are you gonna feel, Dams?
Bruv.
But then also,
she belongs to the streets.
But it's a good thing though.
Wait. Can you? He just said Chris Benoit, yeah. He was a wrestler who killed his family. He killed his family.
What, in real life?
And then he killed himself.
In real life?
Yes, in real life.
Really?
Yeah.
Chris Benoit killed himself?
Yeah.
Why?
So he's saying that's what he'll
mental
do.
Mental health, innit?
I'm not really? Saying that much.
See, this is not reduced.
I didn't know that.
Reduce what, anything, why, here, please.
He killed his whole family?
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of his sons still alive, actually.
Oh, was it?
Oh, my Lord.
So what? Was he in the house at the time?
No, I don't think he was.
Okay.
Oh, my God, I didn't know this. But yeah, no, that's but at the same time, you can look at it in two ways as a man. You can be like, oh, I dodged a bullet.
Mm. No, but that's the thing. I was going to say, I'd have to, for my own sanity,
generally speaking, I would have to say, normally would be, you'd be thinking all these like dumb things.
Look at this whore.
But then eventually you're like, Raj, not yet. I'm good. Like,
well, to be fair, it depends how they broke up. Yeah. If he still loved her when they broke up, fair. If they broke up badly and he didn't care, then it's different.
No, but either way, after five men, it'd blow.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure
the first one will probably hurt. The second one, and then you're like, what is going on here?
I'm sure you've got exes or girls you've seen before who you wouldn't care who you see them with.
Yeah.
Because you don't have feeling for them. But it might be that girl that got away, you might see her thinking,
but also the ego trip.
This is the fifth girl's mouth.
But remember the ego trip as well, because it'll be like, future.
Yeah.
Like the ego trip is you as a man.
As you feel that future is above you or
no less than like him as a man's up. I could treat you better than future. You know I don't have
no and it's true. You know I don't have. I don't know if it's the same for women, but with us guys, like I'm at an age now where it doesn't really particularly bother. I don't care for body counts. I don't. I'm not gonna ask in it kind of thing. But if I hear that you've been with like a certain guy kind of thing, looking at him, it'll put me off. Like I don't even want to say any names because I'm not even sure. If you should know who they are, but there's certain guys that if I look at, I think raw. Like if I find
name out, and
I
get, shame, big man.
No, if I find out, oh, she might have been with me. There's no chance.
But in her defense, what about she doesn't know his reputation in the streets?
It's not about it's not about the reputation. It's more about knowing like literally who he is.
He's basically saying that the guy's a neeks. He's an idiot.
No, sometimes yeah. That there's.
I get it. I've heard guys around me say this though. Yeah. Like, it's like you become tainted.
Yeah.
No, I've heard that, but if he treated her nicely, then what that doesn't really make a difference.
Yeah, to her.
No, but it shouldn't make a difference to anyone. Because like, man, he treated me nicely. But yeah, I think with Memphis, yeah, that's how I'd feel if I was Memphis. I'd be like, future.
Yeah.
Like, Trey Songz, cool. Diddy, all right. The Sun, cool. Future.
Yeah.
No, for me.
His baby mum is suing him.
For me, Justin and
Diddy.
And Puff. That's the winner for me.
Yeah, that's a mad thing.
Father and son.
It's disgusting, man.
It's like when you were going over to their house.
Eskimo buddies.
Yeah. And your dad is imagine being
a penis cousin with your dad. That is nuts.
What the fuck is a penis cousin?
I've heard Eskimo.
Jana cousin.
Eskimo thing. Oh. Eskimo friends or whatever. That's when you slept with the same person.
Yeah. I got that from Scrubs still.
From Scrubs?
Yeah.
As in the sitcom?
Yeah.
That was a show, bro.
Yeah,
I love
best
that.
Show, bro.
It was.
With Donald Faison.
Yeah.
All right, the last thing in my docket before we go over to Gina with her docket.
Don't get me, bruv.
Would you guys be a side chick or side man for $2,500 a week?
Got to increase it a little bit. Yeah.
Increase it. Basically, this is a whole spot on Twitter, isn't it?
Okay. What does my job role entail?
Yeah,
please?
Not to a married man.
What's the
tweet doesn't specify the job specs.
No, it doesn't specify anything.
But
it's just a side chick,
you can take it upon yourself to decide what a side chick is and what a side man is.
To be honest,
$2,500. What are you saying?
$2,500. Isn't that Joe's favorite number for the strippers? $2,500.
So what? Two and a half bags a week.
A week. Mm.
What do I have to do?
If there's no commitment.
As in, he's married or he's got a girlfriend.
No, not married.
And you're fucking, you're going out, you're whatever.
Are we dating?
Side chick antics.
Are we dating?
No, you're a side chick.
Listen. Yeah,
he calls you when and you want something.
No, listen.
We're dating.
All right.
I'm your girlfriend too.
Where makes you sleep at night, love? Yeah. In other words.
Wed, I'm your girlfriend.
No, I'm your girlfriend too.
Honestly speaking, yeah, like, that's hold his on. Business, man. He loves it. I'm just fucking him, man.
Listen. Listen. 2,500 times 4.
I already did the maths. I already did the maths. 120 grand. 120 grand a year.
That's 10 bags a month.
120 grand a year.
Times that by 12.
120 grand.
Minus 20% for tax, but we're not paying tax. This is under the table. All right. So I got myself 125 bags.
I'm dead. She goes, would you tithe it, you know?
Would you tithe
it? Listen, is there any woman out there who needs a side man? I'm loyal. I keep secrets. I stay in my lane.
Yeah. I'm not clingy.
I'm not clingy.
I'm not even going to call you.
I won't text you. Listen.
For two, yeah, I would.
For one, two a year.
Yeah.
Because I'm your girlfriend too, bruv.
Listen.
It wouldn't even, the thing is, my one solemn rule is that I don't approach like taking women praying blank period. If I find you're taking, then that's it kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. You're missing out.
The way he looked at me.
Arm of God. Arm of God.
Put on the armor of God.
Let me ask you a question, yeah? What if the guy was, let's say your partner is married, like legally still married, but they're separated, like as in that they don't live together.
At all?
Yeah.
Mm. Okay, yeah.
They haven't filed for divorce, but they're both living separate lives and they're not filing for divorce because of business reasons or, do you know what I mean?
You know, you have to be separated for a while before you can file for divorce, isn't
it? Yeah.
Yeah.
So they're separated. They don't live together. He lives where she lives. She lives where she lives. They don't speak. They just kind of do what they need to do. Would you still get involved?
Depends on the other circumstances
sticky,
as well.
Man, it's sticky,
are there kids involved? Because kids could also mean that gives you a reason to reconcile after a while.
Because there's people out there that doesn't even bother them. They don't have to be separated. They can still be married in the house and be in a loving relationship and it wouldn't bother them kind of thing. So I don't know, man.
I'd have to see how over you guys are both are. But I said if there's kids do make it a bit more sticky because you might just turn around and be like, you know what? I need to do it for my kids. Because I've been in that situation. Like my first boyfriend when I was 18. Like because his baby mum was giving him like issues about seeing his child. So I said, you know what? She's acting like that because she still wants you. So if you feel like there's a way that you guys can reconcile for the sake of you and your child, go do it. Like I told him that. So I was like, it was literally becoming toxic to see like he really wants to see his daughter, but the baby mum's acting up. And then I was like, yeah, like if you feel like you can go, like don't worry about me.
That makes sense.
There's a bigger family unit that you got to think about. So yeah, it depends. But if they're like separate, no kids, like, yeah, then why not? Because as long as you're going to file for divorce, then yeah.
Listen, take my Monzo, innit?
Listen,
send me my money, bro. So I can get the alert. Listen.
Yeah, you need that Monzo alert.
No, Monzo alert, you give know me so much joy.
You know when your sound is on, you hear the change, the ching.
Oh, what? Is there a change thing?
Yeah.
No, my phone's on silent.
Yeah, but when your phone's on, it's,
it makes it sound. Yeah.
It makes it sound
like,
even if you're in the app. If you're in the app, it does it as well.
I swear.
Even if your phone's on silent, if you're in the app.
The money's calling.
I love that shit, bro. But I hate it when you're sending it out and it does that same fucking sound.
Yeah. I don't even hear the sounds. All right. Gina's docket. Can't wait to hear what she got from the shade room. All the way from the shade room.
Like, YouTube always does this. Piss off, man.
Tea time with Gina.
All right. Damn, can I get some of them bears, please? I'm feeling a bit peckish, mate. Cheers. You want some? Oh.
No, I'm on a diet.
Have we got any more?
All right, cool. So, did you guys see this about the guy who hates his kids? Yeah. It's not funny.
Laugh like that.
How can you laugh?
Go back to the party room.
Do you want to know why? Because
was it you?
No, we were talking. It could be me in 10 years. Basically, in our group chat, yeah, we were talking about it. Yeah, and funny enough, one of our guys said, "This sounds like something busted, right?" So I was like, they're really like, it's to me, I understand why he might feel that way, even though I think it's
ladies
loose.
Avoid him.
it's loose, but I get it because like
what is it that you're getting?
I understand not wanting to have kids.
Yeah, and
feeling like you have to have kids to be with your
that
partner.
Person, exactly.
Because like he said, she gave him an ultimatum and he picked.
Yep.
He kind of picked her over himself, basically.
So he made a choice.
And it's a choice that he has to now live in.
And he regrets it.
That's it. So I get it. However, he's moving mad because you need to just leave.
And you know
the reason why he's talking like this is the fact that it's because he's still there.
Yeah.
So he hates her, not his kids, right?
No,
he hates the kids. He hates the kids
because of her.
No.
But the center
he hates the kids because they exist.
His kids because he doesn't want kids and he only had kids because she wanted kids. And
there's one sentence, there's one sentence that actually me last month. He goes,
armor of God.
He goes, they're amazing children.
Yeah.
but I hate them.
But I hate them. Anyway.
No, I don't think he hates them. He just hates having
no,
them.
No. Let me read it.
He says he has
I never
no
wanted kids, never saw myself as a family man. I now have 3 kids. They are all amazing. I hate them more than anything.
He has 3.
Hold on. I hate being needed. I hate the whining. I hate how they've ruined my life. I hate how I can't do the things I want to do because they exist. Wow. I also resent my wife for making me choose between losing her or having kids. She gave me an ultimatum and I've realized I made the wrong choice.
What, 3 times?
I don't hate children in general. And if other people want to have kids, more power to them. But I feel like this is the biggest mistake I've ever made. The stress is so bad that I was put on a 72-hour suicide watch at the hospital. I would rather kill myself than continue down this road. But I'm trapped.
Boy, I had these kids.
I made this terrible decision. So now I have to do my best to be an amazing dad for them. And I do my best just because I hate them. It doesn't mean they don't that they deserve a shitty life. I get no good emotion from being a father. Hearing them laugh or tell me they love me does nothing for me. This bit finished me. If my wife and kids died in a fire car wreck, I doubt I'd even cry.
Guessing.
I want to leave, but they don't deserve a broken home. And by the time they're 18, the economy will probably be so collapsed that it will be normal for several generations of families to live under one roof and I'll be trapped. I want to leave them, but I was raised better. And anytime I start to put my escape into motion, I feel guilty. Not sad, just guilty. Right. Do you know, does anyone here watch How to Get Away with Murder?
No.
So in this season, she goes to rehab and there's a lady in there in rehab who's been there like 3 times and she's a busybody. And obviously she's like really friendly with everyone and whatnot. And then like they're having like a heart to heart and she literally says, I hate my kids. And she was like, oh my gosh, she starts crying. She goes, you must think I'm a terrible person or a terrible mother. But I actually hate my kids and I have to come to rehab to get away from them. Like I hate being a mother. Like I actually hate it and I hate them and they're so beautiful. But whenever I look at them, I just get really angry because I never wanted them. I didn't want to have kids. And I was like, do you know what? It's obviously from the outside looking in, we're laughing and stuff and saying it's banter in it and like just whatever. But I can understand, but imagine like, and again, you've made the choice in it. So it's a choice you have to live with. And ultimately it's regret. But having to be in a position that you generally never really wanted to be, but you decided to compromise and you realized that you took the L, but the L was even too much for you to take. Ultimately, it can end like you're the person you just mentioned, of course.
But the thing is,
but you're a grown up, bro.
You know this guy?
Mm-hmm.
He's got 3 kids.
Mm-hmm. Are they triplets? 3?
I don't know.
Bro, 3!
Because, okay, cool. The first time around, babes,
fine.
I want to have kids. I don't have kids, but I'm going to leave you. So she kind of roped him into whatever. It happened 3 times.
But then it could be a case of...
It happened 3 times.
No, but then it could also be a case of she got pregnant. They didn't plan for her to get pregnant.
Yeah.
And she got pregnant. She kept the baby. I've got a bedroom who...
Yeah.
Yeah, no, but 3
What about
them?
the other 2 times?
No, I'm saying if the first time... it was okay, cool, I'm going to give you one child.
Yeah.
And then the second time it could have... Do you know what I mean? I don't know. And I don't know about the third, but what I'm saying is I've got a bedroom who had a daughter with his baby mum and she wanted another child and he didn't want another child. Like, he was literally against it. Like, no, I don't think we're ready. Papa didn't want another child. And then she trapped him. Not trapped him, because they were together at the time, but she got pregnant, basically, and she knew what she was doing. She went on the pill. He thought she was on the pill and she got pregnant. And he was mortified.
Well, I get that. But what I'm saying is...
He had 3.
For someone who hates kids so much and hates the idea of being a father, he didn't really take much precaution to not having kids.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from the one...
He could even got a vasectomy behind her back.
Might have 3 kids. So
and not told her.
Stop crying, big man. Reduce it. Because you... Listen. The thing is, I understand we're all different, innit? But I do find it hard to understand how people can have hate for their children.
For their kids.
Yeah.
I get it.
For anyone.
Some people don't want to have kids. They don't want the responsibility. They don't want the burden, whatever. And when they're there, it's like, shit, my whole life
I can understand. But I can understand
to hate
how...
these bundles of joy that you've created.
No, but you know what? Not all bundles of joy are created in a bundle of joy way, though. Yeah. So if you were raped, God forbid, but if you were raped... okay, maybe I should have put a trigger warning or something. But do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, that's true.
Yeah, of course.
Your child was conceived in a way that wasn't of your consent...
Yeah.
I can understand why you'd have that feeling towards your child, because every time you see them, it's a reminder of, and it's not their fault, and it's not your fault either.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you get what I mean?
And there's a, those are very different circumstances. Yeah. Exactly what you used to say is, she gave you an ultimatum and a choice, right? And you just, you made that choice. So regardless of whether you didn't want to have kids at before, when she's giving you that ultimatum, you made that choice. If you really, in your heart of hearts, did not want to have kids, then you realize that's not the woman for me. And we shouldn't be in this relationship anymore. No, and you should go find somebody who wants to have kids and love you that way. And I will go find a woman who doesn't want it. Because there's loads of people that don't want it. They just want to have a dog.
Yeah. Mm.
And you can chill at home. No. But you can't now be in this situation saying, oh, I hate them. Because then what are you, what energy are you giving to those kids? Like, what energy are those kids living in?
Mm.
And I can say that because that's the type of reality. Not that I feel like my dad hates me, but I feel like my dad wasn't meant to have kids. Like, my dad is the type of person that does, like, he makes decisions like he's still single.
Mm. Mm.
And then it's like, but you chose to have kids. And what energy are you going to put into those kids? Because you're saying, oh, I want to be the best dad ever. But how are you going to be the best dad ever if you don't love these kids? Because there's certain things that you do as a parent.
It's purely out of love.
Purely out of love. You don't want to do. You don't fucking want to go drop this child off to do what they want to do. You'd rather sleep in. Do you get what I mean? But you do it out of love.
Sucking what? From where? The babies from the neck.
Yeah, when people suck the baby.
That's nasty.
But it's like, if you genuinely did not want to have kids, you should have just told that woman there and then, do you know what? I love you, but we're not on the same page. And let me go find someone that's made for me.
Mm.
And you go find someone made. So all these type of stuff, I'm just like, no, you're...
The thing is, yeah,
like, you're moving
right.
mad.
You're right, yeah. But the reason why I said I understand how he could feel that way is because it's kind of like what Gina said, yeah. He probably didn't envisage it being this bad. And it's got to this point where he's like, no, I genuinely feel this way because I made this decision. I didn't actually really think it through, and now the manifestation of his bad choice is the fact that now he genuinely hates these children now because of his bad choice. Not because it's not their fault, and he's not blaming them per se. It's just literally his bad decision making has led him down this path.
No, yeah. I hear that.
You know what I mean? So again, I'm not saying he's not even like, there's no reason why anyone should hate, unless your kid is flipping Damien or whatever. There's no reason why you should hate your kids, kind of thing. But he's put himself in a position now, and that's why he feels that way. But it's not right, innit? But I understand how he got there, because
three. You understand how he got to three?
Of course, because if he didn't even want the first one, of course gonna hate the third one. Like,
no, but how did he even get three?
Is what I'm saying.
Like, how? Because you could have got a vasectomy after the first one, just not even told her you got the vasectomy, and then when you're trying to have kids again, like, oh, sorry, we can't. Like, how did you get to three?
I don't know, man.
Did he type this with his identity out and open?
Or that's, it came
nah,
on,
it's
it
just
came
one
Reddit.
Of those. Yeah, it's just one Reddit, of those anonymous things.
Okay, because I'm thinking this is a crazy
thing.
I saw
another story this week, actually, with babies, yeah, where this lady was talking about her cousin, saying that her cousin wasn't feeling well. And then she went to the doctors.
And she's pregnant.
She went to the doctors and she was pregnant with sextuplets.
Uh-huh. Oh, I saw this.
4 months.
And she was, the friend was like, could never be me.
Yeah. Bro, those babies must have been tiny, bro.
4 months pregnant with sextuplets.
Yeah, because they're tiny right now. At 4 months, a baby's not.
No, that's what I mean. Yeah.
Like, what would you do?
If my girl was pregnant with six babies.
At once, fam.
Stress.
Stress and stress.
How much money that is?
It'd be like, only one of you can go to uni, so pick one.
No. Do you know how much money that is?
What happened to Monday?
One kid is expensive enough.
Yeah.
Six.
At one time.
I'm going to have to get on my job, bro. Throw things.
Bank, you need to be a jobs. Side man.
Side man. Listen, ladies, I'm being serious.
You're a better man than me, boy, because I'm out the door.
What?
Wait.
What?
What is this?
Wait, what do you mean? Stop.
Sorry, what?
Wait.
You're out of the door.
What do you mean?
I'm joking.
You're leaving her. You're not joking.
That's what I'm saying. There's a guy telling me he's going to get married. He didn't get fucking married, bro. Go back to the party room. The PS4 forum. Get fucking married, bro.
No, honestly, I genuinely would faint. That would be my reaction.
I'm not going to lie.
I think I would faint.
I'll take whatever God blesses me with, but please, not six at a time.
Six is...
That's mad.
That's like my mum's friend that was...
Stress.
My mum's friend, something similar happened.
He must have, like, come back from the army. Yeah? He
six!
He must have had sex in, like, 2 years or whatever, and he's just unloaded straight.
Because
like,
even triplets would stress me out.
Yeah.
Even twins would stress me out, bro.
Thing is,
twins already stress me out.
Fam, one child was stressed.
Yeah. One little, but twins is like, it's a nice little blessing still. Yeah.
The thing is,
triplets is great, but six.
In my family, like, one of us is likely to have twins now anyway.
So, oh, really?
Yeah. I got twins in my family as well, actually.
So,
I don't have twins.
My mum's a twin. My two uncles are twins.
Oh, you definitely going to have twins.
You know, there's a lot of twins in Nigerian families. Like, most twins I know are Nigerian.
Yeah.
It's big
That's
in your...
That's true, you know.
It's big in your... How?
I don't know, man.
Genetics, I guess.
I don't know how it happened.
My money's on my brother to have them do it, to be honest.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Isn't Diola's family full of twins?
Fam, let's not even talk about them, bruv. Literally.
No. Head of twins.
Because my mum's friend, that's what happened. She had one child. Then she was like, oh, let me get pregnant, do another one. She had another child. She said, let me just get pregnant one more time.
Yeah.
I'm good. She had twins. So she's like, okay, let me get pregnant one more time. She had triplets. Yeah. So she got seven kids.
Mad.
Wow.
And like, I was just like, ooh.
Like the twins, my cousins are twins. Their mums, the twins' mum and her sister both have twins.
Mm.
Martin, Hassan Hussein.
Yeah. Oh, we. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay, yeah. So their mom and their mom's sisters. Mad. All right, Jean. That's pod, Jean. That's pod. What else we got?
All right, next.
From Bossip. Bossip.com.
Oh, didn't that Lizzo lady make them apologize? Because you know they have the most outrageous.
Who the hell was Lizzo, please?
You know who Lizzo is?
Mm, I've heard of
her. Why men great till they gotta be great?
On my life, yeah, I'm not joking when I say I've never heard a song of hers. I've literally only heard of her.
All I know is that little bit of I just took a DNA test and I found
I'm that bitch.
Yeah, and that and the reason why I know who she is because she apparently stole that from someone on Twitter.
Did you see her on when she did the BT was and she was
I haven't heard
she would she was with, she danced with a flute.
Yeah, she does all the time. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, she can play a few instruments, can't she? And she twerks with the flute.
Okay. I would not be looking out for that.
Why? Are you sizist?
I'm not. What?
He doesn't even know. Do you know what she looks like?
No, I know what she looks like, but I'm definitely not a sizist, no.
Anyway, sorry. So I'm not work okay. What should I do?
Oh God.
What would you do?
Get up on my feet and stop making tired excuses.
Okay. So I'm not working at the moment and my boyfriend is driving with Uber. But instead of renting, we thought it would be better for him to use my car since he doesn't have a car at the moment and would have to rent. So we both win. He can give me the money to pay for my car note and he saves money instead of renting. Only problem is we've had problems in the past about him having another woman in my car. So I'm always calling him to make sure he's doing it right. Or I'm paranoid that he's making stops in between. I need some advice. What should I do?
Wait, repeat that?
Repeat it because this guy was breathing bare on the mic, brother.
So basically, her and her she's unemployed and she has a car and her boyfriend is an Uber and Lyft driver.
Mm-hmm.
But instead of renting the car from them, he's using her car. So rather than renting from Uber, he pays her like her car note, her finance, and uses her car. So she's just like, brilliant, my car's getting paid off and he gets to use it for work.
Mm-hmm.
But in the past, he's cheating, I'm assuming, because she said we've had issues with him being, she goes, we've had problems in the past about him having another woman in my car.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm always calling him to make sure he's doing a ride or I'm paranoid that he's making stops in between linking other females. I need some advice. What do I do?
Just leave that relationship if it's gonna be that deep. Yeah, leave
it. If you're doing that, there's nothing's worth that stress.
You're
going about your day. You think, oh, yeah, let me call my boyfriend to make sure he's not cheating. Like, you know how stupid that sounds. No point.
And when he's at work, it's not even like he's at work.
Did she say he cheated before?
Well, she said we've had issues of him having other girls in my car. So I'm assuming, cause that's what she said, she's paranoid.
Yeah. Even if he didn't cheat, that's what, not how, the relationship to be car, staying
outside of him doing the Uber.
Yeah, I'm assuming so, because she says, I always call him to check whether he's actually but on even, a job.
Listen to that. They think of it, I always call him to make sure he's on. Can you imagine how stupid, like, how that? Annoying would that be that you're trying to make some money and your girl's calling you to make sure that you're not fucking around?
You don't even want to do this shit.
Yeah, like...
But yeah, like, you don't even want to fucking drive an Uber.
If I'll leave her, but what should I do? No, I'll be thinking about how can I get out of this relationship? Like, I don't need this car, man. Like, get out of here, man.
Yeah, like, sis, if you're in a relationship and you feel like you need to...
need to allow it, man.
Keeping tabs on someone like that, let it go,
like,
man.
The thing is with relationships, so once the trust goes, yeah, just dead it all. Like, you're wasting time. You're wasting everybody's time. Like, if there's no trust...
No fighting you, man, no?
No, if the trust is gone, what's the point?
No fight.
None, cuz.
Fuck it, man.
No. It's not even about fucking.
Yo, Captain.
I'm telling her. Because the mistrust seems to be on her side of the relationship.
Mm.
And I just don't feel like that's a healthy environment relationship to be in.
Even if the mistrust is on her side, yeah, if the guy gets a whiff of it, right, and you think, oh, yeah, my girl don't trust me,
I'm not being funny. If I think my girl doesn't trust me, I'm not going to even waste time because there's no point. It's not going to be a fun relationship to be in anymore. Yeah. It's not going to be. So I might even cut losses before she even thinks about them because there's no point. Once the trust is gone on either part, you're wasting everybody's time.
So you don't think that trust can be...
It will never be the same, I don't think.
Gained back or... The whole thing could be flipped around.
I don't think
once someone doesn't trust you, they're gone forever.
Well, we don't have the context, so we don't know whether he actually did cheat. That's different. Yeah. But if he didn't cheat and she just being a paranoid, anxious person, then that's different.
Forget the context there. Think of it, you guys like ask yourself the same question as well. If you're in a relationship with someone and you can't trust that person anymore, are you gonna think to yourself, there's gonna be a point where we can fix this. Like if the trust is gone, like genuinely gone, are you gonna feel like we can fix this? Because what's gonna make you change your mind? Unless all your paranoia is proven to you, all the evidence there for you to trust that person. But this is life. There's no CCTV 24/7 kind of thing. You're not gonna be able to see everything for you to get the full context. So even if you're wrong, kind of thing, you'll never fully know anyway. Kind of. So the trust is gone from the beginning. For at whatever point, and it's done. Like it's done. You're gonna be doing things with that in mind, thinking I can't trust this person anyway, kind of thing. So
very true.
And then on the flip side, if you're getting a vibe from your partner that I don't feel like they trust me, or whatever, you're gonna be doing things thinking, well, fuck it anyway. Like it doesn't really matter because you won't believe me if I'm doing this. So like you're gonna be so like blasé about everything. It's just gonna be a big mess, man. So forget it, man. Like once trust is gone, it's gone.
I agree.
That was Pastor Dammy with the word,
the truth.
No,
the word.
I agree.
Truth in the booth.
It's just toxic.
What's our predictions for, even though this is going to come out the day after, what's our prediction for the AJ and Ruiz fight?
I don't really watch this.
Oh, stuff, do you know what? I'm petrified. if he knocks him out again, I'm so scared.
Yeah, listen, AJ, he has to win.
He has to win for the man game because...
And he's lost hella weight for this fight.
No, I don't think he
lost a lot of weight from what I can see.
Let me check what he weighed at the first fight.
I think
he
lost a lot. Well, visibly anyway, he's lost a lot of weight. But no, AJ has to win this fight. It's an absolute must.
I just like the fact that he's playing, like he's not, I wouldn't say he's playing the villain yet, but he's not here for gig. Like every time I've seen him on camera, yeah, there's no smiles, there's none of that. He just wants to win. Like, and I like that. Like he's fully, you know, like, remember when Vegeta turned evil?
Margin then.
Fam, that's what AJ is right now. No, he's not here for games, guys. And that's what's making me scared.
Anthony Joshua, he has to win.
If he loses, I'm finished.
No, the thing is, do you know in life when like certain things have to go a certain way or the war's going to end?
Yeah.
This is one of them.
How can you say the world is going
to
end?
No, you know what I mean, isn't it? Anthony Joshua cannot lose again to this guy. It cannot be a reality.
Let me ask you. So if he does, what happens after that? Is that it?
It's a myth. Fam, it's a myth for his career, bruv. I'm not saying his career's over. But listen,
how do you come back from
that? It's a massive, massive loss. Like he's gonna have so many doubters.
Yeah, and you know what? Yeah, what's funny? This Ruiz guy. Yeah, if you look at him, even at the meeting they had today, kind of thing. Even though he's the champion, yeah, he just looks like he's happy to be there.
No, because he's happy. He didn't think he was gonna beat AJ.
But the thing is, you said it, but once he gets in the ring, it's a different story. That guy he's actually scary.
He's a very good boxer.
But outside them, you just think he's just some. Any, do you know what it reminds me of? Actually, do you remember that Simpsons episode where he has to fight the Mike Tyson lookalike?
Yeah.
That's how the guy is built.
So Homer is Ruiz.
Yeah.
You know what it is? If you're honest, a lot of this has to do with his look and his physique. That's what it all is. Because if Joshua lost to Wilder, it wouldn't be a big story.
Mm.
But because it's Ruiz and he looks like how he looks, it's a.
He moves nuts. Like
he's fast.
He's scary. He gets in the ring, he boxes your head off, man. Do
you know you're gonna do a mukbang on the weekend?
Why?
Seafood mukbang.
From where?
Hot and juicy shrimp.
I keep seeing their stuff.
A mukbang, what's that?
Bloody fantastic.
What's that?
Oh, when you basically you talk to the camera. You know when you see people eating on YouTube, but they're having a conversation. But most mukbangs are like the seafood boil things. The bags.
You gonna do it?
I don't mind.
I mean, I just want to eat.
So you go and eat seafood and you record yourself?
Yeah. No, I just want
to
eat.
And you talk.
Why do you have to record it?
Because you can make money.
Because people make a lot of money on YouTube. Have you not seen the woman?
Oh!
Have you not seen the woman with the massive shrimp?
And she's just crunching.
Yeah.
No, what I'm trying to establish is This restaurant, mukbang.
No, no, but name the of the...
Well, a mukbang is just... It started in that Korea.
Are they GM shrimp? Because they're flipping huge.
And I'm not going to lie. I don't think they're legit.
And you're recording it because you want to.
No, but remember, they're just...
That's what you do at the restaurant.
That's just like when you go to Billingsgate and you can get the different sizes of the prawns.
No, I mean, have you not seen some of the ones in America?
Have you seen
that
the way she dips?
They're like so big. The size of them makes me question whether it's legit. It's too big.
It's ridiculous, man. They're pumping in full of steroids.
Yeah, they're huge.
Like the way they crack the tails, they just the sound it makes. And
when they're sucking the juice. Yeah.
I love this shit.
Like it goes forever.
I put it on in the background at work. I like the sound.
All right, guys, can you answer my question now?
ASMR, I love it.
Are you guys going to record because you want to record it? Or that's what you're doing?
No, we're just
going to
eat.
But you just said you want to do it for YouTube.
I didn't say that.
We were just gonna eat.
No, I said that's what you do it for.
Yeah.
I didn't say that's what you do it for.
I thought you were doing some new food thing. I don't know.
No.
No, we're just gonna
Have you not seen... The other day, Sandals came across it. There's a girl, an Asian girl, and she chews sugar cane.
Oh, really?
But she's got like 5 million views. Like,
bro, they've got
and
mad
all she, and all
views.
She does is whisper.
Yeah, ASMR.
She whispers and she just chews sugar cane. Like, the camera's literally just here. Mad. On
people
her mouth.
Are depraved, you know.
People, yeah.
They're literally,
the silliest
they're literally over her mouth that's and disgusting. She is literally just chewing like the different, she's got loads of different ones and she'll just be like.
What's the weirdest thing that you see on the internet that you kind of find like a small bit of pleasure in?
Yeah, ASMR videos. I love it.
Mine is like, you know when they pop the pimples?
Oh, no. Yeah, but that's ASMR.
One. Jeff loves those, man. You
What's
guys are
ASMR?
Man.
So ASMR is that's the feeling.
You guys are disgusting.
That's kind of satisfying still.
No, you're disgusting.
No? So do you feel like chills?
No, I don't feel chills. I just like
how do you feel? So ASMR is an autonomous sensory meridian response. It's like when you get goosebumps or when your brain just feels something because of certain sounds.
It's a satisfaction feel.
Yeah, that's still ASMR because your body is doing like a response to
pop
that sound.
Pop that pimple, B.
No, I don't get it. It just looks nasty to me.
And then,
do you remember on Snapchat, there was, they put, what's the guy name of the guy? Dr. Pimple Popper, I think his name is. And he had a channel.
Yeah,
and every day they update it with like his new thing. And sometimes he'll come like, I watched a couple in it and it just made me feel sick, but he would have specials like, okay, we've got this person coming in with this amount of this or that and it's just, they're huge and, you know, can't wait to see you. I'm thinking, like, it's nasty.
No, I get it. I'm engaged.
Wow.
I'm engaged.
Wow.
I don't know if I have.
No, I don't watch them now. I don't even follow the pages, but a few years ago, they used to pop up on the timeline. Yeah. When they first really became popular,
yeah.
I was into it.
Yeah, you and Jeff are different. I think, I don't know if I have anything like that. I think.
No, I don't think so.
No. Okay, I tell you what, no. On my Insta Discover page, do it. It's bear cat stuff. Like, just bear cat stuff.
Yeah, because you've got a cat.
No, but even then, like,
you have a cat.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but having a cat in real life doesn't always translate over to socials. That means you follow cat pages, you're liking cat stuff, you're searching for cat stuff, right?
Yeah, I know.
Exactly.
Yeah,
when they put like little.
Let me guess, is your cat called Salem?
No, it's not Salem.
What's it called again?
I'm so dumb.
Stimpy.
I think Salem was better.
Salem just sounds like a witch's house.
So G, I'll let you know which one, yeah?
Stimpy.
If you want to order.
You men are doing all your private... Listen, do this after the podcast.
I'm still engaged.
Cast. Have you got anything weird, like a little quirk thing?
Yeah, I love ASMR. Like, I love watching...
See, I've heard of that before.
B Loves Life. I love watching B Loves Life videos.
Is she the ghetto one from America?
Yeah, fucking love it. And she got the green screen with them in the water.
Yeah.
Love it. Fucking love it.
She just crunches.
And then she goes, have you seen the woman who does...
No. I do have one, actually.
The pickles. Have you seen the woman
It's the doctors, the chiropractors. When they crack people's backs. My God.
This is all part of ASMR. Because ASMR isn't just eating. Because some people do, like, Japanese art.
So it is,
and that sound.
So is porn the ASMR then, really? Is it?
If the sound of it, yeah, it could be.
What, mac
if
and cheese?
The sound of it.
This guy, dirty.
Ew.
Cretan.
The sound of it does something to you. Yeah, that's what it is. Because it's the response that your body has from that sound.
No, chiropractor videos, yeah. Oh my. There's one year where the guy, yeah, like he sets her up. So like he puts her like in a certain position, right? Like, so he's like, okay, are you cool here? Then flips her this way, then that way. Then he goes, don't move. And he goes up to her neck and he pulls her neck. And when I tell you the sound it makes, it's like, I can't describe it, but it's the most satisfying thing. He pulled her neck, but her entire back cracked.
You're into this, bro.
Bruv, it's flipping. It's the most.
So, G, if you had a YouTube channel, yeah. Gina, if you had a YouTube channel,
sorry,
and you, it had to be like left, it had to be a bit quirks. Mm-hmm. What would it be?
What do you mean quirks?
Like something that's not left, normal. Left field.
But it doesn't have to be sexual.
No. Okay. Oh yeah, hold on. What happened to our page? What's it called? OnlyFans.
I never had the OnlyFans.
No, we're gonna start.
You lot are dumb.
We were. We should do it though.
We're gonna do the OnlyFans page.
You guys are sick.
Get the money.
We'll make money.
No, they do, man.
Stop chewing on the mic, man.
But we have to be in a relationship, so it makes more sense.
And the sumsum and the dum dum.
Exclamation just for emphasis. And then I'm because you were simple.
Pibble.
Hold on. Should this episode be called Armor of God or simple bibble
bibble? No, it should be SB.
SBZ. Shred. All right, go on. What would it be?
I don't know.
Dammy?
I'm about to make a YouTube page.
Yeah, but it had to be a bit quirky. It can't be just like you playing games or something.
I don't know, man. Oh, got one.
What is it?
Me digging at my eyes.
What, the sleep in there?
I've got a nasty habit.
And what, you'll put them in like a collection jar?
No, I've just literally be like digging at my eyes. Like, I used to do it a lot. I've calmed down now though. My friends used to, growing up in school, they'll be like, how do you dig out your eyes? And then when I went uni, came back, I was still like, you still do this shit? It's like, it's a habit.
Man would be blowing my nose and collecting the snot in a jar.
Oh my, what
ew.
The?
Ew.
Seeing how much I can collect in a week.
No, because you know what? You do that?
No, I made that randomly, but you know what it is? My mucus never stops, bruv. It just never stops. I blow my nose 10 times in a row, yeah, and it's still mucus in my nose, bruv. It's mad.
Man, I'm going to see a doctor about that, man.
Trust me, allergies and that. Anyway, Crystal, what are you saying?
What do I do?
Complain about being single. I'm playing them.
I don't complain about people.
Oh dear.
Fuck you, bro.
That was a dig.
That was.
I don't complain about people.
I'm joking. Look.
No, on the road. Do I complain?
Oh, Jesus. Gina, what have I done?
We're not.
Armor of God.
I don't think
Armor of God. What cans have I opened here?
We're not going there.
I was joking.
What would I do? Give legal advice.
That's not a quirk thing.
That's quirky.
It's not.
While twerking.
No.
That's fair to be fair.
Wild twerking.
Oh, maybe I'll give like tutorials on how to give head.
That is to the left.
That's OnlyFans page. That's not YouTube.
No? I don't know. I don't think I can do really weird things.
Crystal, so why don't you start? No, I'm joking.
What? About giving head?
All right, so, okay, cool. Let this be your first episode. Teach us, teach the listeners, teach the girls who may not be, you know, that well-versed in the art of tongalingus.
Tongalingus?
Hold on.
Neck.
Brain.
Last week, yeah. Wait. Last week, I mentioned Throatzilla, yeah? Wait.
Oh, yeah.
Not in context to me. This girl tried to act like I experienced it. I said, no. One girl tweeted something to the degree of, when Gina implied that Yusuf had experienced Throatzilla, and it was a gif or something, innit? Yeah. And then I retweeted it, and then someone on Twitter called for a Zidane was like, huh? With a question mark. And then I looked at the page, it was like a porn page. Yeah. I'm like, I didn't experience you, big man. I said to the girl, delete the tweet immediately.
That is hilarious.
I was like, huh? You experienced me. I just saw dicks on the page.
Oh, wow.
That's the real Throatzilla. Obviously, we know who we're talking about. And I didn't experience that person.
Let's keep it up.
Too funny.
What was I going to say before that happened?
I bought my tutu.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, go on. Yeah. Oh, look at her, she was ready to go back to it.
She's even getting her notes out. She's ready.
All right, go on. Tell us.
She doesn't need notes.
Tell us. Give us, you know. Take like us there.
We're listening.
Step. I haven't done it in a while. Because obviously, right. Man's been single.
Allegedly.
No, I haven't.
Okay, that's fine.
It's not alleged.
That's fine.
How do I start?
How do you start?
I talk to it nice.
Pop off.
They get what I mean. Do you know what? What I do, yeah, is like, I like lick the top. And then lick the rim. You know the rim?
I said the rim. You know?
No, I'm
you
know dead. She legitly talking.
I said spinners.
You know the rim underneath. You know the rim underneath it, underneath the head bit.
Yes, 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 I get
so
you.
So I licked that rim bit.
Nah,
swear.
Yusuf was like, yes, yes, I get you. like, take me there. Like, what you call it? ASMR, whatever. Like,
do you know? Reduce it.
Yusuf is having a virtual experience right now.
No, yeah. But, so relax. You lick the rim a couple of times.
Okay, okay.
And then like, you just kiss the head. You don't put it all in your mouth.
Gina, relax, man. Go on, Crystal.
Wait, she's serious? Oh my God.
What?
No, Crystal, I'm always. I'm here with you.
And then you just kiss the top, but you don't like, put it in your mouth yet.
Mm. Oh my God.
And then you start licking the shaft.
Mm. Ladies, like, I hope you're listening. Up and taking down. Note,
shaft. Oh, yeah.
He's a bad mother. Shut your mouth.
But you don't close your mouth, but you're still like licking the shaft.
Wait,
up and
have
down.
You kissed a bit. Kids, this is where you stop listening.
I mean, oh shit, kids, it comes out on Sunday.
The kids are already in bed. no.
And then obviously...
The kids are in the mouth.
No,
I'm joking.
Yeah, and then like you start sucking it. And then if you want to do like extra, you like give a hand job while you're sucking at the same time. Well,
two stroke.
Yeah.
Oh, the double hand twister.
Yeah, the double hand twister.
So they get the what? Free father gong. What does that mean?
It's the playroom chat. Playroom chat.
The PS4 playroom forum.
Yeah, and then
it's party chat for goodness sake.
Sorry, party chat. Sorry.
That's it. And then deep throat a couple of times, and we're good.
Is it
the double hand tongue twister?
Sometimes if I'm feeling generous.
That's the double twister 3000. You know. With built-in speed controls.
You're actually
and heat sensors. ripped for pleasure. Anyway.
I'm so done.
Oh my God.
If you're feeling a bit generous.
What was it?
So you're actually going to start his OnlyFans page?
Well,
like, it was a joke, obviously.
It was a joke.
How does that thing work, though?
With fans only?
Yeah.
Like, people pay to access your page.
Right, and on your page, you can put whatever you want,
yeah,
right?
So yeah,
most people
content.
Use it for porn stuff, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
And then people
so
pay.
If I wanted to like put my toes on there,
someone would
do it. That's what I'll do. I'll start a page where I'll like sit on men for money.
But our OnlyFans page was going to be like everything from the feet.
Yeah,
like,
no faces.
No faces or masks.
Yeah, we did say masks. Yeah.
The thing, there'll be one idiot out there will recognize us.
I would. I'm not gonna lie. I would know your body, and I would know your body easily.
Wait, ain't that you? Them abs look mighty familiar.
Or like, that technique looks familiar. Like
oh shit,
Brent, can you take that bit out?
That's his finisher. I've had that before.
Brent, can you take that bit out?
What about
the head instruction? Bit.
No, I'll stay there, big man. That's staying all the way.
Mature content.
That's a real mature content.
No, you're gonna have to put a trigger warning.
No, what? Do you think our fans are kids?
It's true.
They're here for it, bro. They're here for the XXS content.
Mate, someone might even have a pen and paper, brother.
Exactly, rewind, like, exactly,
start again.
All right, as we've got a little, what seems to be an intermission here. Live show, not live show, sorry.
Movie night
is next week, Sunday.
Ooh-hoo.
Grab your tickets right now. It's a Christmas special. Tickets.
I'm a bit ashamed to say this, but I have never ever seen Friday After Next.
That's because you're too busy in the party room, Dems. Mm.
The party fucking chat.
Party chat, sorry.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're watching Friday After Next, which is a Christmas-themed movie, because it's a Christmas-themed movie, net. So yeah, get your tickets. It should be fun. Sweets, popcorn for free. We'll do a little mini live show at the end.
Mm-hmm.
Quizzes as well.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, get your tickets right now. Link is in the description.
Tickets, get your tickets here.
Get your tickets. G, have you got a scene by Just Jean?
No, because all I've been doing, I ain't had time to be honest. I've caught up on Godfather of Harlem. Which
someone told me to watch that, man.
Is it good?
Yeah.
I'm going to start tonight.
Yeah. And that is about it, really. I haven't had the time to watch anything else.
That fat yawn, bro.
Sorry, I'm very tired.
I can see.
And do you know what's really sad?
Go on.
I'm not going home after this.
What are you going?
I have to wait until 2 a.m. to go to Smithfield's Market.
Pardon?
Oh, to buy stuff for the
brunch. For your brunch. Oh, wow.
Are you going to the brunch?
No, I didn't get a ticket.
Oh.
Can I get can you add me and I'll pay?
There's no more seats, bruv.
No, but I can bring my own chair.
She will break. That's what we call friends.
I'll bring my own chair. I'll bring that.
I'm hosting still.
I'll bring the folding one. Yeah. I'm being so deadly serious, Gina.
But
can I not bring my own chair?
Dirty tea.
Huh?
We should be able to.
Just let me know. I'll pay on the door. I don't mind.
No,
I'll pattern it.
I'll pattern it.
What time?
Pattern it.
3 p.m.
Sunday, yeah?
Yeah, can you get that too? Thanks.
Oh, what? Sound check?
Yeah.
Wardrobe?
Just confirm to me.
Hustleism gear. Hustleism gear, yeah?
We can go there afterwards, actually.
Wait, let me know if I'm wearing hustleism. If not, I'm going to dress myself.
Okay.
Yeah. I can look sexy for the bitch.
What are you watching right now, Jeeves?
I've stopped watching, not Snowfall. Intentionally, Snowfall, because the site I'm using is moving higgy. Mm. But Snowfall.
I really need to start that.
I need to start Godfather of Harlem.
I guess I can talk about Snowfall then, but I haven't.
No, because you might be past me now.
Trust me, I don't care.
Are you on season one?
No, do you know what makes me laugh when you guys were discussing Snowfall? And Gina was saying, did you get to the rape scene? You're like, oh, look at the spoiler.
And then he clocks that. We'd already been talking about
I'm on season 2, episode 7 or 8, I believe, or 9. I can't remember.
I think you're, I don't remember where I am.
Yeah. But you know what, I need to get into it. When is season 4 coming out? It's not coming out soon.
I haven't started it myself.
Okay.
Is there anything else, like, on Netflix, though?
Explained.
That's worth watching. Like, that's a series.
Explained.
Okay. What's that about?
To be honest.
Explained is that different episodes every day when they talk about just different things.
So oh, one was I've about seen cults, that.
The other one was about billionaires.
I've seen the racial wealth gap.
It's really, really good.
Do you know what? I watched, actually. I forgot the exact name of it, but it was a Donald Trump. It was on Netflix. It was Donald Trump documentary. And basically, what it was, I didn't realize it until...
What, Donald? Was it called Donald?
I don't know if it was called Donald. Basically, it documented pretty much his life from the beginning.
Yeah, I think it was Donald.
And what the smart thing they did of it is that by the end of it... it was something to do with presidency. I think that's what was in the title. But I didn't really realize it. I was watching because it was interesting. But basically, what they did, they showed how his path to the presidency actually came about and how they were suggesting basically that it was all deliberate. You know, there was the rumor that he didn't actually want to run for president. He didn't actually want to be president. He was just seeing how far he could get basically.
Mm.
And now he's sitting in office not knowing what to do. He's just basically just messing about kind of thing. But this, this documentary showed that every single move he's made was to get here at some point.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? The documentary is really, I'm going to see if I can find him, but it's so, so good. And for me, I can almost tell, just by looking at someone sometimes, that, okay, this person is a bit weird kind of thing. And, they're a bit off kind of thing. But all the stuff they're showing about this guy, it was mad. Like, some of the things he would say and some of the things he would do, it was like, how can you not know this guy is not rap too tight?
Mm.
Like, he number one, he's probably the biggest narcissist on the planet.
Biggest.
Number two, he's definitely the biggest sociopath. Like, that is not even up for debate kind of thing. Like, so many of these things that he was doing, like, all these power moves and what he was doing throughout his career, it all pointed towards this, to being essentially the most powerful man on the planet kind of thing.
Mm.
So I'm going to find the name of it. I'll send you guys the name, but I think it's definitely recommended watching. It's really, nice. Really, really, really good, man. Yeah.
What's it called again?
I'm going to find the name. It's on Netflix. It's on Netflix. I want to find the name.
All right, we get the name, we'll tell you. All right, then. If there's no other further business, let's do Song of the Week. Song of the Week.
Oh.
Who wants to go first?
I'll go.
Anyone.
Do I have to?
I'll go.
Yeah. I'll just send you the...
You have to get... Brent, have you got the wire?
Mm-hmm.
Someone tap
Brent. He's not been here, boy.
Have you got the wire for play the songs of the week? Sorry, bro.
Anyway, Brent, I thought you'd be engaged. I was excited to talk to you this episode.
Platinum Chanel cologne and I stay...
Dressed to impress. Spark the bitch's interest. Sex is all I expect. To watch TV and the legs. They know. It's quite a price for. Left the club tipsy. Say no more.
All right,
except
right.
How I'm getting
is
home
that how I, is that how annoying I am?
Yes.
Annoying? Fuck you, bitch.
Finish off.
Oh, are we doing the same song? Yeah. I thought you'd moved on.
No.
Wait.
So why doesn't everyone tomorrow pick their favourite Jay-Z song?
Mine is a Jay-Z song, actually. But it's not my favorite Jay-Z song. Okay. It's just a Jay-Z song.
Mine wasn't going to be based on...
Yeah, mine, I don't have a favorite Jay-Z.
I have a few Jay-Z songs.
No, Jay's too powerful. You're going to get this podcast taken off.
It's true. No, that's very true. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Fuck
him, man.
I was going to play Tory Lanez.
But wait a minute. If you play Tory Lanez, it has to be 30 seconds because that's new.
Really? What?
Yes.
Take it down.
Mm-hmm. Big man, we already got taken down once.
Really? What, the pod or the YouTube?
The whole pod. For Drake song.
You're gonna like this one actually.
For Drake song, how thingy was it, Drake song?
It was new. It was a draft day off that care package he released.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, yeah. So this one you're gonna like.
We have two more strikes.
Really? All right, let me find a different one.
Let me send it to you.
Okay, yeah. I know what I'm gonna play. Oh wait, how new?
All right,
I'm gonna play.
If it's really, really new, the industry rule is 30 seconds, is what I've been told.
All right, I'm gonna play.
You should know, you work in the music industry.
But I don't know, sometimes it's a bit.
Okay.
Or maybe I should just play Sony one, then I can whitelist you when I get to work.
You can what?
Whitelist you. Put you on a list that means that you can play Sony songs.
Bruv, do that anyway.
No, but it has to pop up. It has to pop up. No, so just. That we see it.
Go on the database and just say.
No, but I don't do it. It has to flag up.
Yeah, but
and then I
if it flags up, you ain't gonna know it flags up because you don't work at that department.
I do. It's Columbia. I'm working.
So are you monitoring the flags?
Our social media people monitor it.
But do they come to you and say, oh, Crystal, we just seen this flag?
No, I'd be like, oh, something flagged up when you put it up. But I can't do it off the back of nothing being flagged.
It'll be too late then.
I'll get out of here, man. I'm not playing it. I'm just gonna have to fucking make one up then.
You make one up.
Because it's not what I've been listening to.
What song was it?
Stuff. Tory Lanez.
Yeah, it's from the Chicks Tape 5.
Chicks Tape, yeah.
Yeah, play a quick bit of it. Because I played some of it on album cuts and that hasn't been ripped down. So.
Oh, has it? Okay, cool. No. So, actually, nah, fuck it, no. I'm going to do Wale from Wow That's Crazy.
Yeah.
The Routine.
Okay.
Love that track.
Hit us. Quick sports report. Quick, 2 minutes, yeah. Emery has gone.
Bro.
This pod obviously is a week late, but listen, when I woke up in the morning, yeah, it was Black Friday actually.
Bro.
Woke up in the morning now. The day before that, I had some anxiety. I was getting through it. I was like, this man's presence is giving me anxiety. I woke up. It was a good day. I went to the bathroom. I came back, checked my phone. Here's a Sky Sports app alert saying Arsenal sacked Emery. It was joy. Dami, talk to me. It was joy.
Bro, one of the first things that, like, I was gassed because I was in bed when I saw the notification myself, kind of thing. But I didn't. All I saw was the BBC notification. And I went to the Arsenal page to come, and literally tweeted it like 5 seconds after I checked.
Bro.
Things. So I was like, oh my god. So yeah, it gassed me, like, because it's been a long 18 months.
Bro. One of the happiest days of my life, bro.
So yeah, that was great. Freddie's in. We're good.
No, Freddie's not in and we're good. Freddie is
we're good,
interim manager.
We're good. He put out
a Higgy first team on his first game, which we drew to bottom of the table Norwich.
That's fine. Do you want to know that's fine? Because Emery's gone.
Yeah, Emery's gone. But now we move on. And please, Ljungberg, we're playing tomorrow as well, Thursday. Yeah. Yes, Carmelo is back in the league. He's bowling.
He's back.
And Lala's back. Is back as well.
That video of her showing the sun on the phone.
To see how
disgruntled she looked. Yeah,
she was vexed.
She looked like this.
Yeah, she goes, look.
Look at your cheating ass daddy. Yeah, look at him.
No, but she was there though.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You're there. You can't be disgruntled.
To be honest, yeah, she owes him anyway for doing the sex with Tommy on TV, fam.
Oh, please.
Big time, fam.
Do you see when she was cussing? Is it Max Kellerman?
Yeah.
But saying he hates Melo.
Put some respect on Melo's name.
So get out of here, man.
But yeah, man, Emery out. Listen, I was celebrating my story, but it was happy time.
Wait, who you got winning the East and the West?
Winning the East, I've got the Bucks.
Same.
Winning the West,
I said Clippers.
It's tough, but obviously, I'm a LeBron fan, so I want the Lakers to win.
I think the Lakers will do it.
But the Clippers team is good, bruv. Yeah. Clippers team, I'm thinking in a 7-game series, can the Lakers beat the Clippers? I hope so. But listen, the Clippers are good.
Yeah.
And when they start to get rolling properly, but I really, really hope the Lakers can do it. Hopefully the Lakers can add someone, maybe like Iguodala or someone.
Kawhi's load management is going to come in like clutch as well.
Yeah, because he's not going to... Well, after All-Star,
yeah,
probably chill load management. And then end of match.
You know why that's so dangerous? Because you've got guys like Lou Will who come off the bench.
Yeah.
And just drop, give you 25 and them numbers there. Like, Lou Will was a baller, bruv. Oh, that video of Melo, bruv.
Yeah.
Going for the rebound.
Fuck out of here, I got it.
That video.
Yeah. Get out of here, son.
Oh, no, wait. Let me play it. Obviously, listen, not really going to understand the funniness of it. But if you understand the context of where Kamuna Anthony is in his career and where he was and what he's fighting for, this clip will kill you if you're a basketball fan. If you're a basketball fan, this is Carmelo going for a rebound the other day, yeah? He's fighting for that contract.
Yogi Alexander outside sets his feet.
Melo is fighting for his contract.
Did you hear the one from the other night where he was like, shoot that motherfucker? And the guy missed. And what did he do? He got the rebound afterwards.
Carmelo saying, look, I'm fighting for my life.
Wait, do
I have to have that soundbite? He is fighting for his life. He's thinking, because he's not, contract's not guaranteed, isn't it? Until, now if he's still with the team after the 5th of January. Yeah.
His contract's not guaranteed. I didn't really pay attention. Nah. His contract's not guaranteed.
He got player of the week last week, man.
Yeah, he got player of the week, but not based on stats, because Luka and Harden were above him.
Yeah, we're definitely, man.
Do I have that sound?
Luka is terrifying. Not playing.
Like, he's terrifying, man.
Luka is not.
No, you know why Luka's terrifying? Because he's 20.
Yeah. I know. That's,
but Luka plays like that because of European basketball.
Yeah,
right?
No, Luka is
just the way that they play here
baller.
Is different.
And the thing is,
do it there is
he balls out effortlessly as well. It doesn't look like he's even trying. He just cash, knocking down threes, lay up.
I just know he finishes each match and eats like 2 double cheeseburgers as well.
Nah, but do you know what makes me fucking laugh even more? When Ben Simmons got his first 3-pointer, and then the way
teams.
That it was everyone, NBA.com, everyone, I just like, people need to respect this
guy. Why would it have to be that? It would be the Knicks. That's what annoyed me.
The fact that he doesn't even take threes is baffling to me.
But some people don't, because even Giannis doesn't really take threes.
He does now, but...
Yeah now, because everyone said if he wants to be another MVP
when he takes threes, when he takes threes, he jerks back.
Yeah.
He doesn't look comfortable.
But he's only taking threes now because people said if he wants to be MVP again this season, he needs to learn how to take threes.
He will.
And to be an all-round better player,
to
be a LeBron's level, then cool. Yeah. And obviously, he's in this position now where the two best three-pointers are out. Clay and
Steph. Yeah, but he ain't.
And Steph.
Yeah, but he's not in the running for best three-pointer.
No. I'm just saying, in terms of when you're looking at MVP stuff for the year.
Oh, okay.
If they're looking at our three-pointers, whether he's improved, the best three-pointers are out. No.
Yeah.
So now it's like everyone's all trying to get into the game with their 3 points, but.
No, I hear that. All right, let's wrap it up. I've been the party room, party chat. What else did you say today?
Armor of God.
Armor of God. If I had 6 kids, it's a crisp Benoit thing.
No, I did not say that.
That's what you said.
No, I said I'm out of here. I said
if. Oh my God, Gina, when are you going to let... This episode should be called If.
Let it go. Gina, grown up.
I've been Dami, aka Rob Lucci or Lob Lucci. Yeah.
Is your thing Rob Lucci?
Yeah, Rob.
It's Rob or Lob, depending on where you follow him.
Yeah.
No, Rob Lucci and Lob...
Lob Lucci on Twitter and Rob.Lucci on Instagram.
I didn't know that was you. I see your time.
Really?
Yeah, your tweets.
Oh, really?
Mm. Fanboy.
Man's been happy, boy.
No, I chill, man.
No, he's been happy.
No, he said fanboy. No, I just see your tweets sometimes.
Oh.
I'm not popping like that, man.
I hate the people who I don't follow and I keep seeing their tweets all the time.
Oh,
see, yeah. That's man. I don't know how to turn off the setting as well.
That's because someone I know
likes it.
All right, go on. Who's next?
I've been...
Gina is finished.
What did you say today? I've been
over it.
And she's been finished.
Over
at least
it.
About, at least an hour.
I've been my back.
My neck and
my back.
Who said that?
Gina.
No, it's from Friday.
I know it's from Friday, but when did you say it today?
Oh,
no, earlier.
Oh, I need.
Ruin it, bruv. I've been Gina.
Sorry. Oh, I missed that one for him, but it's a bit sensitive. Something to add to his
docket.
Yeah. You know what I'm talking about?
Look. Oh.
Yeah. That's a bit edgy.
I have been Mr. If. If.
Let it go, bro.
If. My dentist is in Peckham.
Bruv.
Peckham.
If.
They ain't no wrong with Peckham.
No, I come on SN1. Bang,
bang. SN1.
The family.
Oh, hold on. Did you see that thing about the...
Nando's?
No. Should we talk about the pod? It's a bit sticky, isn't it?
Oh, wait, hold on. Talk about afterwards.
The group of guys who are going around robbing and stealing.
No, I haven't heard about it.
You haven't heard about it?
Mm-mm.
What are they called again? Anyway, certain people were implicated in this group. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, wow.
I see something.
Wed were talking off air.
Yeah.
Oh, do you know what? Actually, sorry, I know we're doing the outro here, but did you guys see that guy? It came out earlier this week, basically. Do you know those Ring doorbells, yeah? You got the camera on it.
Yeah. He robbed the house and he looked in the camera, yeah.
Bruv, did you guys see that?
Listen, oh, the person who's got
He looked dead in the camera. But what smacked is, when the person saw that, saw his image, basically, they've managed to find, like, his socials or whatever, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
They found a picture of him and his baby mum and the baby together. They found, like, another picture of him as well, kind of, like, the baby mum's face is just everywhere now. She's obviously got nothing to do with it.
Oh,
That all came about from him robbing someone's house.
Oh, damn. Were they white or black?
He was black.
Oh, damn.
He came in there empty-handed. He left here with a backpack and, like, a Tesco bag of this stuff.
Oh, Lord.
All right, guys, don't forget... Are we finished? Everyone done?
No. I have been
Throatzilla
Gawk Gawk. Double Hand Twister 3000.
I'm dead.
Double Hand Twister.
I was just about to crush you there. Advice.
With built-in saliva that come out the pores of the fingertips. Armor of God.
Nah, Brent's taking that shit out, bruv.
No, he's not. He ain't. Because then he has to take all the other context that leads to it.
Yeah. No, you can take
that
out of me. I
don't care. No, man. Don't come and ruin the pod, bruv. It's not coming out, bruv. It's not coming out. All right, cool. Yeah, so guys, don't forget, movie night is next week. Get your tickets right now. Come and enjoy with us. Friday after next. It's going to be hilarious. And yeah, see you guys next week.
Peace.
Peace.